Do you like say while you were on that show and why?
Oh, jeez. I have no idea. I really don't have any idea on that one.
Yeah. Okay. So how many people you want to bring with you, like, if you were a celebrity, and like, what, like, to tell the funniest joke to you, like, how big of a crowd would you want?
I just keep it small.
Yeah.
Just friends.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Cool. Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you.
Is that okay?
Some of your favorite subjects?
Honestly, live questions.
Yeah.
I don't even care.
Okay.
Is there anything you like, sports?
Music? I mean, well, I'm into everything.
Photography?
We're good.
We're good photography.
Yeah, like you just ask me whatever.
Okay.
What's the date? It's
not that long.
Can you talk like a pirate?
No.
That's
really
good. All right, okay. Is that Portal that you live in?
Yeah.
How do you feel about these questions?
Honestly, can you just, like, not even do these questions, just, like, ask me randomly?
What about the Academy of Finance? Because I go to Creek.
Okay, you can ask me, like, one question about them.
Cool, cool. So, what's your name?
Adam.
Adam.
Tell me when we're starting.
Okay. We good? Okay. We good?
And you're on.
Wait, when can I look?
Whatever. Like, you can look at me at the camera.
We on?
Yeah, we're on.
We're on.
Yeah, we're on.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, so I'm here with Adam. So,
Alifghani.
Okay. That works. So you go to Creek, right? What school do you go to? And
I went to Creek for the past 6 years. I've been in the Academy of Finance, as you can see in my hoodie. Do you know Miss Holloway?
Yes, I do actually.
Yeah, me and Miss Holloway have our little thing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I'm not trying to talk about it. Next question.
Okay. Very nice. So what does the AFO, like, what does that stand for? And
it's
like
actually AOF.
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 Okay. What did I say?
AFO.
Okay, I'm not in the Academy.
Restate the question.
Okay, so the Academy of Finance, like, what do you guys really do, like, in the class, and, like, what's your favorite thing to, like, learn about?
We learn about finances, mm-hmm. and I really like learning about finances.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have, like, a lot of friends that are in that program?
I have, like, a solid 2.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I'm pretty freaking popular, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. But we got homies all over the place, mm-hmm. like, you know, all Port Orange, we're straight, we're on the map.
Yeah, are you guys, like, are you really, like, when you grow up, do you want to be, like, in finances and business and stuff?
When I grow up, I'll be all about my money, like, nothing but finances, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, we're straight.
Yeah, definitely. Okay.
If you could do anything in the future,
okay, yeah, so if you could do anything, like, in the future, what would it be, like,
get finance-wise? My finances, bro. You know what I'm saying? I get paid.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, for, like, a job, like, what, do you want to work in, like, the stock market or something? Or?
Any job that gets me paid, I got it. I got all jobs, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What is it about money and finance?
Yeah, so, like,
bro, money, root of all evil, you know what I'm saying? I am the evil. You feel me? Like, we straight.
So, like, with the Academy of Finance, like, what, like, because you have to take, like, certain courses, right? So, like, what course would, like, you, like,
I'm
you
not
just
even
don't,
in
like,
the Academy of Finance. That's a bunch of bullcrap. I just like finances, you know what I'm saying? Okay. We out here, it ain't much.
Very nice. Cool, thank you.
Can I rap?
Yeah, you can totally rap.
All right, yo, check me out. Yo. I got bars. I bought a flipping rhino. I got rhinos on deck. They call me the flipping rhino. Yo,
okay.
Hop up on my flipping rock. I gotta go.
Okay.
Thank you guys. I appreciate you guys handling me.
Thank you. Oh, did you sign out?
You gotta sign out.
Wait, where do I sign out?
So you just print your name.
Is there a way I can watch this interview?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, finance, $5.
Yeah.
No, that was good.
And then this is an official Guinness World Record participant sticker.
Appreciate it. What do I need? 10 what?
10:30.
You guys ready?
Appreciate it.
Oh, thanks.
Be careful.
Yeah.
Oh, well. Oh. Just like write them on one of these cards.
Where is this?
In my bag.
Back up because I'm sending two more people up there.
Oh, awesome. Good. Thank you.
So she's signing out. With that, so
I'm signing out. I'm
sorry.
You're totally right.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, what's your name?
Amy.
Okay, cool.
And you are on with Miss Amy.
Okay, so I am here with Amy. So did you ever like look into UFOs to see if they're real or not, or what?
Not really. I've never really thought about it too much.
Yeah. It's just not something that comes up every day?
No.
So when do you normally think about aliens and why?
I don't know. Like if it gets brought up, sometimes you see stuff on the internet. That's pretty much it.
Yeah. Okay. So have you ever like done any research stories about aliens and why?
I haven't, but I've seen things on the internet, like I said, like on BuzzFeed and stuff, but that's about it.
Yeah, I know there's like the History Channel, or maybe it's like the Discovery Channel, does like documentaries on it sometimes. Do you ever watch those for free time?
No.
Okay. So if you got like abducted by aliens, and like, would you ever write a book on your experiences about that and why?
I would not write a book, but I would hire my father to write the book for me.
Yeah.
Yeah? He's an author, so... Yeah.
Awesome, that's great. So there's a lot of different TV shows about aliens. Would you ever watch them, like, in your free time? Or if you, like, you had literally nothing to do, like, why would you watch them?
There was one show, I think it was on ABC, it was called The Neighbors.
Okay, yeah.
They only played it for one season, but I thought it was hilarious. It was about aliens.
Awesome.
Not real aliens, but it was pretty funny.
Yeah, cool. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Awesome. Okay, so I already signed out. Did you sign one of the other forms?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Excellent. Is someone else jumping ahead?
Okay.
Here, you remember this?
Good. Okay. Someone else wants to jump ahead. Maybe,
nice.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'll give you a second.
Yeah, I'm standing here.
20 seconds.
Okay. Okay, bye. Why would they? I am here. Yes, I'm standing next to Paulina. Okay, bye.
Hey, what's
up? Huh? What do I do? Okay, so you can
sign
here, but there's
one of
these forms inside.
How old are you?
16.
Right.
What?
You have to be 18 or have your parents sign the mono release.
Who has a charge? I can't claim to be everyone's legal guardian.
I wouldn't even attempt.
What? I'm adopted?
Because what happens is they're going to check every mile and they'll look at it.
There's been some other people that weren't.
They all have parents.
Star Wars? Yeah.
I'm not sure.
I see both of them.
You don't even want to go there.
Bring both of
you.
This is really
somebody here.
That's good for him.
That's a good one. That's good. And we can make up questions too. If you want to make up something, it would be really good.
Okay, you could have asked me this one. Which one? Oh.
Sorry.
I didn't know that was a problem. Let's see.
Answer!
How far are they from here?
I don't know, but they wanted to come by and see this anyway, so.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah.
Who's your first? Bring them.
Just because I watched it today does not
or go
mean.
Meet them and then
oh, love Twilight. But the Vampire Diaries, I don't know if you've seen that series.
Go meet them.
Good.
Okay, the Vampire Diaries.
I got you into it.
You're welcome. And they're like way hotter. And they're like half naked way more often. Okay.
So answer.
I'm just saying.
Then that'll happen.
No problem.
That's a pretty important part.
Yeah.
I just wanted not to come back. Because if they caught.
Hey, Dad.
Bourbon. And so I was like, what is this bourbon of which they speak? And so, like, I forgot about it.
I'll be right
back. Be like the vampires. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is my new favorite thing.
So, how are you feeling? Probably pretty tired.
Yeah, I'm getting tired.
I am so tired. I woke up at like 6 this morning.
Yeah, same.
You've been here for like.
I woke up at 6, I got here around like 8:30, and then we started at 9:30, and then, yeah.
Wait, so you're going until 9 tomorrow morning?
Oh!
Yeah, good stuff.
How many do you have to, or how many more do you have? Is this number 252?
Yes, so I need like 300 more. Oh, hey! Okay, cool. Cool. Okay, cool. So you can sign one of these things really quick.
Here, give this to him to put with the others because we're getting
they're,
here.
They're under there, in that folder.
These are blank. These go to his truck.
Oh, really? Hey, Douglas, I have some more of these, I guess. Okay.
And they're all in one place, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
They're all going to this van.
Okay.
Okay. Not his. I mean, Paul's van. Yes, they're all in one place.
What's the date?
Today's the
22nd. No. How you doing?
What's your name?
Michael.
Okay, cool. And then I think we need to turn the camera. Hey, hold on. Let me ask. Can you turn the camera? Wait, what'd you say?
Do I need a...
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah. Wait, what's your name again?
Michael.
Michael, okay,
yes.
Cool.
You're live.
So I'm here with Michael. Okay, so Apple's iPad, like, Retina display is actually, like, manufactured by Samsung. So, like, what
I'm
the
appalled.
Heck?
I'm appalled. I know. Know that.
Yeah. Like, what the heck? So do you think Apple or Samsung is better, and why?
Okay. You know, actually, I tend to switch phones around every 6 months or so just to play around, try to keep up with technology. So I personally like Apple just because, as well as how integrated it is. I have Apple TV, an iPad, a Mac, you know, so it's just nice that it's all integrated.
Yeah.
Samsung's got some pretty cool products, and they're doing some really neat things, and they have a lot more, I guess, ability to customize and stuff, too, so that's pretty cool.
Definitely.
Kind of on the verge of maybe going to the Samsung, Apple, you didn't hear that, but I really do. It's hard to let go of the Apple phone, you know. They just do such quality products. Yeah,
definitely. I had an Apple for so long, and then I finally got the Galaxy S5, and like I really like it, but I might want to switch back over. I'm not sure. It's hard.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. Apple just makes it so easy with the phones. You know, everything's just it's so intuitive, and just easy as you're going through the menus and everything. And the one thing's nice for Samsung, if you really just want to geek out, you have so much ability to customize and really get it to where you want it to work for you. But it's a lot more work to get to that point, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, and Apple's already got to figure it out.
I know, and especially when you have like all Mac stuff like I do.
Yeah.
Like nothing syncs up with it. So
no, you're right.
Like,
you're right. Yeah.
So, yeah, it's hard to like
go
back and forth.
Definitely.
So if you bought a new app, like a new Apple phone, what would it be and why?
I guess that's going to be an easy one. You got to go for the iPhone 6, right? Because that's the newest one. But just for fun, I'd like to get an Apple 1G just to compare, right? Just have both.
Yeah.
You know, just have a little fun and see how far they've gone and. In such a short period of time, too, because I guess it was probably, 05 or so?
Yeah.
When the iPhone first came out and changed the world?
Yeah.
Right? And that wasn't too long ago.
Like this big? Like,
yeah. Well, it was like from that big to that big, and then we're going bigger again. Yeah, so that's pretty cool.
Crazy. Yeah. So what features do you like best about your phone?
I guess I got to go with the calendar, the menu, and email. I mean, that's the biggest. Not the phone feature, by far. It's a phone, you know, but the phone feature is probably the last part I like using. Text messaging, email, calendars to keep me in line, to-do list, reminders, little bubble witch, Candy Crush here and there, right?
Yeah, Candy Crush, that's like the
Definitely,
way it is.
Yeah.
So how often do you wish that you had like a different iPad?
It depends on the situation. On a plane, smaller iPad, right? At home on a couch, bigger iPad.
Yeah.
That's what... I guess it depends on the situation, the environment, but yeah, I have an iPad Air right now. Absolutely love it.
Nice.
I tried a, you know, you can go to certain places and get some tablets now for really cheap costs, right? Typically like an Android type device. However, pay a little extra money, get the iPad. It just works so well.
Yeah.
It's very, again, intuitive, very fluent, and it just moves nice. And yeah, I love having that feature yeah. compared to some of the Android. Nothing against Android, again. So hopefully you don't have an Android sponsor here. I apologize. Yeah.
That's awesome, though. That's great. So have you ever worked for Apple?
I'm not a genius, but I'm not. No, I never worked for Apple. Yeah. No, it'd be great to work for Apple. They have such a great company, great philosophy, good leadership in there as well. But I don't work for them.
I know. I feel like it'd be cool to get like all the discounts. And,
That would be really nice.
Yeah, you know. Yeah. It's like, oh, I got like a cheaper iPhone. Like,
oh, I know. Yeah, save $5. Right? Yeah. Whatever it is, you take what you can get in life,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, really. Yeah. And you know, test everything out. That'd be really
sure,
cool.
Sure, sure.
So what? So like, do you know? Like, okay, are you gonna get anyone an Apple gift for this Christmas?
I might give myself an Apple gift this year. I did give my wife an Apple iPad for one of our anniversaries, and she absolutely loves it. It's her, it's the iPad 2. I got it for years ago, but I mean, she just absolutely loves it, uses it all the time. It's actually kind of interesting because, you know, there was recently the new iOS that came out. They had a new software version that they released, and there were some bugs. It was a little buggy at first, like any software version, and as soon as I knew it was available to public, I'm like, I gotta go update all our devices, right? My phone, my iPad, my computer, her device. Everything else works fine. Her device is just slugging along. Yeah, yeah. And I was just hearing complaints left and right. But luckily, Apple released the 8.1 that took care of some of those issues.
Yeah.
So I took care of that update for her, and it's just flying, and she's happy again. Awesome. And she has all the latest features. So so we're all happy. Happy
good.
Apple household.
Yeah. That's the worst is like if something gets like too slow.
Yeah, definitely.
Add one? Okay. Okay, so actually there's like a Pebble, and there's something that goes with like the Samsung.
Oh, yeah.
Like have you ever thought about getting one of like the iPhone ones?
You know what? No, I haven't looked into it too much. You know, it's funny, and I won't be too far away from that. I run often, and I use the Nike TomTom watch, so that syncs up with satellite, right?
Yeah.
But I know Apple and some of these other companies, especially with like healthcare, it's going to be really interesting because they're going to start getting into this realm probably about, you know, we're wearing your watches, and it probably won't be long before your watch is like reporting to your insurance company of how healthy you are, how many steps you're taking, right? That's going to happen in the future, but as far as right now where we're at, I know with the Apple Watch, it's coming out. It's not an iWatch. I think they just call it the Apple Watch.
Yeah.
I could be wrong on that,
something
too.
Like that.
Yeah, but it's not an iProduct. It's just different. I don't have that yet. It'll be interesting to see how that goes. I know some people that have, like, the Samsung Watch or so, and they have it linked into their phone, right? Mm-hmm. So they get a text message. They're able to look on their... So I guess it's good if, like, you're in a classroom, especially in a university, and, you know, you get in trouble sometimes for picking out your phone or maybe in a movie theater or a restaurant on a date.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you pull out your phone, that's a no-no.
Yeah.
So that time, just checking the time, maybe. That could be bad, too, you know?
True.
But, yeah.
Yeah,
so it's interesting to see how that technology will be received and everything
true.
Else. But I don't have one yet, but it'll be interesting to watch that unfold.
Awesome. Yeah, cool. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Awesome.
Pleasure
meeting
you. Thank you.
Yes, nice meeting you too.
Thanks.
Oh, great. Thank you.
Oh, good, good.
Yeah, you just keep talking. I can be like that too sometimes. I was like, talk about
good.
Okay.
Oh, you're next.
I am. You're next. I'll
take
sign or
something. Sign out.
So, what's your name?
Rebecca.
Okay, cool.
Hold on. Nice. Beautiful hair.
Oh, yeah. Big hair.
It's like,
huh?
Nice and big. Yeah. So, I'm here with Rebecca. So, do you know like the characters from the Dirty Dancing movie?
I do. Actually, I grew up in a small town in Virginia where they filmed Dirty Dancing. The funny part is, when they were filming it, I was 8 years old, so it was too dirty for me to see. So I learned all of my characters after the fact, but Baby and Johnny have a special place in my heart.
Yes, definitely. That is so cool, though. Oh, my goodness. So what's like the best dance move or like Broadway show you've ever seen?
That's tough. The best Broadway show I think I ever saw actually was Wicked.
Yes.
It was wonderful. They had great music, a great story, great dancing. It was all It was the perfect package as far as that's concerned. Yeah, yeah.
Totally. So did you ever see that show in New York City?
I did not see Wicked in New York City, but you can't beat a Broadway show in New York City. There's nothing better, I don't think, yeah. You know? But they did a pretty good job in Orlando where we saw Wicked, so.
The Bob Carr, right?
Yes, yes.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Is there a Broadway show that you're just like dying to see, like one maybe that's come out recently or anything like that?
One I'm dying to see. Actually, as old school as it is, I would love for them to bring Cats back because Cats had some really excellent music and the costumes and the makeup were amazing. So I think that would be a really cool thing to see in Broadway.
Yes, I know. Like, if you ever go see a Broadway show anytime soon, Once is a really good show. Like, it's all about the music, but yeah, it's amazing.
Awesome. Yeah.
That's really cool. So how often do you like go to like see Broadway show? Like, do you ever like buy the merchandise at a Broadway show?
Yes, and that's funny because I actually, as I was trying to figure out what to put on today, found a shirt that I got from the Cinderella Broadway show.
Oh, yeah.
And it reminded me that every time I go, I buy something silly just to remind yourself of how awesome those shows are. So.
Yeah, that's great. That's so cool. I know. I always find myself like, oh, here's another Broadway show, you know, like shirt kind of thing. So do you usually get like the discount seats at the show or like you go all out front row?
We go all out front row. I did discounts once online, which was a good deal. But once I got to New York City and saw that line that wraps around, you know what I'm talking, the one where you can get the discounts?
Yes.
I couldn't do it. Yeah. It's way too long, too impatient. But front row all the time. Yeah. It's the best.
Yeah, like how else would you be able to see it? Like, really. So is it like worth the money to get like the front row seats at the Broadway shows?
I think so. I mean, in the Broadway shows, they're good venues, so you can see the show from anywhere, but the best is front and center.
Yep. Perfect. Yep. Well, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Awesome.
And we're going back to music.
Staying up all night out here? Yeah.
Yep, until 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Oh, there's more. Actually, it should be really interesting. The later it gets, I would think.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I feel like
Walmart. Oh yeah. Yeah, you get the
real one.
And if any, there might be its own document. Yeah. If you're limited to the spot, going around looking for people, that could be a lot of fun. That could be a lot of fun. Yeah.
Okay, go be something like that. Okay, I'm here with Sophia, and this card is backward. So Cats, like, they actually can't they can't taste sweetness. So or like anything like sweet. So have you ever given any cat like something sweet?
I gave my cat like an orange. I guess that's sweet, but he didn't like it.
Oh, okay. He just like
pawed at it, looked at it, walked away.
Yeah, definitely. What is this? Okay, now. So 70% of cats like live their lives like asleep. So, what would like you do if you were a cat?
I would definitely sleep. I already sleep probably like 80% of my life now, so I'd probably be backtracking a bit on my sleep time.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. So how often does a cat meow around you?
Cats, like, they try to communicate with me a lot because I have, like, a telepathical, like, connection with them. So if it's, like, a cat, it's like, boom.
Okay.
So they don't even have to meow because it's just kind of subconscious. Mm-hmm. Like, their aura sends the energy of their brain waves into my brain.
So that you guys just talk to each other all the time?
Yeah, I just go.
And I that's what you were saying. That was weird. Wow, that's crazy. Oh my goodness. So how, like, do you like long-haired cats or like short-haired cats?
I like all kinds of haired cats. But if it's a short-haired cat, those ones tend to be sassier than I feel than long-haired cats. And I believe that it's because long-haired cats have the struggle of long hair. And so they've learned a lot about their lives and about, like, how the struggles of long hair in life. It's really a metaphor for poverty. So I like them both.
Yeah, you like them both, but like the long hairs have like they have more meaning in life.
Yeah,
or something. Yeah, that's great. That's really good. I need to get some long-haired cats then. So what would you do if like a cat came to your front door?
I would kidnap it. I would not try to find whose cat it was. I would not put out posters. I would not take it to the vet to see if it had a tracker. I would take it into my home and keep it for the rest of its cat life. And I would love it. And I would pet it.
Okay. So, if you had, like, one cat and like it, would you ever get, like, any other cats?
Well, I have a cat right now, clearly. He is a short-haired cat. Okay. He's very sassy. His name is Kitty.
Okay.
Quite sassy, like this level. Yeah. And so would I get another cat? Yes. Yeah. Especially if it came to my door. Like, I probably wouldn't even get a cat. I would just go camp out in my neighbor's yard and take one of their cats.
That sounds just wait for it to come to you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Awesome. I like talking about cats.
Yeah, cats. I do too. Just cats.
Cats. Meow.
It leads to injury. Other, that would be your problem. 5 of you were coming, but it takes 4 minutes. And also, help you with the questions. Here, you got to fill out one of these.
It's a waiver?
Yep, exactly. You've done this before. You don't have to know that you're that's me. I'm the photographer. That's me. Oh, no, this is very real. We've got 260 people already. Now you don't need to know that the
What's your name?
Beatrice.
Beatrice. Hi. I had a friend from where is she from? It wasn't Thailand. What is it?
A little closer.
I don't remember what it's called. But her name was what is it again?
Beatrice.
Beatrice, yes. Okay, yeah. I know, but we always called her B, so it was just like okay. Are we good?
Yep.
Okay. I'm here with Beatrice. So, okay, what is your favorite like transportation while going around New York City and why?
The train, it's the only way to get around. Well, there's bus too, but train is the fastest.
Yeah, definitely. I would say so too. It's also the cheapest.
Yeah.
So describe your best like Broadway show that you've seen and why.
Ooh, the best Broadway show must be Cats.
Cats?
Yeah. It was in Broadway for a long, long time, and I saw it before they retired, and I think they brought it back, but it's a great show.
Yeah, that's great. So if you only have like $5, you know, for like lunch in New York, where would you go to eat and why?
It'd have to be Gray's Papaya on 72nd and Broadway. It's a famous place. You see it in a lot of movies, and they have great hot dogs.
That's very cool. What's it called? Shake Shack? Is that what it's called?
Yeah, that's really good. You can get, I don't know if you can get whole burger with $5, but you probably get fries with $5. Yeah.
Cool. Thank you. Okay. So imagine you only have like 2 hours to see something in New York. What would you want to see and why?
I'd say you'd have to see Central Park. I don't know of any other city in the world that has such a beautiful park in the center of the city or the heart of the city like New York City does. And you have to just go and check out Central Park.
Central Park is amazing. It's like cute. It's like it's crazy. So if you ran into Brad Pitt while jogging, what would you do and like what would you say and why?
Well, New Yorkers, like, we see famous people all the time, so like I would say I would wave hi or something, like I don't want to creep him out. It's just the New Yorker thing. You see famous people all the time running in Central Park and just walking up and down the street and stuff. So I'd be like, hey.
Hey, what's up? How you doing? Okay. Having fun? Sweating a lot? Yeah. So how many times would you want to see like Harry Potter, like, or wait, hold on. How many times would you want to see Harry Potter movies, like if Daniel Radcliffe was sitting right next to you in the theater?
Probably none, because I'd want to talk to him and pick his brain.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Cool. Thank you so much.
You are very welcome. Good
Thank
luck.
You. Thank you. Yeah, you can call me Path. People call me Path.
You can call me JC. I'm
JC? Okay, cool. Hi, nice to meet you. Okay. Cool, and I'll take you. Cool. Yes. So, I'm here with JC. So, how many...
I'm nervous now.
I know. I just, I can't read. What is this? Okay. How different are you from, like, your other competitors at work?
Oh, well, I'm obviously the best.
Yeah.
Best at everything. work every single day, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
But definitely my motivation to be influential in the world. That's how I separate myself.
That's awesome. That's really good to, like, influence people and everything. So how do you handle stress, like, or pressure?
By tackling what's stressing me out. Yeah. It's, you just got to beat it, and that's it. Tackle where the problem starts, sort of thing.
Exactly. Wherever that source is, just, like, stop that. So what's, like, your biggest motivator at work and why?
To get more money, you know, to get paid better and hopefully be able to pay off my school loans and stuff. Yeah.
Definitely. That's great. So how many hours do you normally work?
Well, I would say about, because I kind of work two jobs, so 35 is about, because both part-time jobs and stuff, so.
Awesome, that's great.
I'm a student, so.
Yeah, that's a lot of working, jeez. So, working, like, a new job, like, how long does it take to, like, really adjust everything?
Working a new job?
Mm-hmm.
I would say a month, just because you kind of need to know what you're doing, like, the actual job and task, but then you also need to get to know the culture and the people that you're working with, and so I think that's all part of it. So.
Definitely. And what, like, okay, so would you ever consider yourself, like, a self-motivator?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Of course. Yeah. You got to take a picture of this. Please.
Yeah.
So.
Cool. Okay. Yeah, that's it. Thank you so much.
Can I ask you a question? Is that okay? Can we flip the script?
Yes. Okay, we can flip it.
Is this okay?
Yeah.
So, with this task that you're doing, what do you plan on doing after?
Well, hopefully, okay, so I don't find out if I actually break it until, because, like, Guinness has to go through everything. So, hopefully, like, in, like, a week or so, I end up actually breaking it, and I'm planning...
Just after Thanksgiving.
Hopefully. Yes, I know, like, right after Thanksgiving, I'll be thankful for breaking it. So, yeah, and then I go on with my radio stations and doing more interviews and hopefully getting to, like, my end goal and everything.
What's the end goal?
I want to be, like, a broadcast journalist. So, like, Ellen, Oprah, like, talk show kind of thing. Yeah.
Hopefully you can bring me on your show or something.
Yeah,
that'd be pretty cool.
I'll have to bring everyone that was, like, from my Walmart, like, Guinness thing back onto the show or something.
I think that's a great idea. Yes. But I'd also like to be on that couch next to you.
Yes. There we go. You can totally do that.
Awesome. Sounds good.
Cool. Thank you. Yes.
Appreciate it.
Yeah. Awesome. Thank you. It. Oh, yeah. You didn't explode.
You can kiss her cheek.
Thanks.
Good luck, Billy. You can kiss her cheek. Oh, you got to sign out.
Oh, yeah. And here's you got a sticker?
1108.
Oh, you can get a sticker.
Who's next? You want to go? Are you okay? Yeah, you did a bottle release already?
No.
Okay, we'll do it last. Go ahead and you can go in. And I'll get you when you come on.
Hi. So what's your name?
Peter.
Okay, cool.
And you're on.
So I'm here with Peter. So cats in the 1960s was, they were like spies with the CIA. So do you think you'd make a good spy?
I think I would make a pretty good spy.
Really?
Yeah, I think I can blend in with people.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. That's important to be a good spy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just kind of like camouflage into the walls and stuff, you know? So what type of cat would you, like, want to travel with and why?
At least a friendly cat. That way, I think a bad cat would be probably scratching people all the time. That wouldn't be a good idea.
Yeah, definitely. You don't want to be, like, with some crazy thing. Yeah. So if you had a cat, like, that would wash your clothes, would you, like, want to clone it or something?
Definitely, yeah. I don't have to wash clothes anymore.
Yeah, exactly. It makes life a lot easier. So, how long do you think cats live and why?
I think about 10 years, right?
Really?
I think so.
Yeah. I know, like, dog years, it's like 7 years, like, or whatever, compared to, like, 1 year.
I think so. So cats should be about maybe, what, same, six, five?
Something like that.
Something like that, yeah.
Awesome. Okay, and then what would you want to teach your cats, like, tricks and, like, or, like, make them cool, like, with tricks and stuff? Like, what would you want to teach them?
Oh, man, at least give me a high five with a ball. Yeah, something. I don't know. It's hard to teach a cat anything, though.
I'm sure they're always sleeping.
Yeah.
Cool. Thank you so much.
No problem.
Oh, yes, sir. Just sign. You're going to fill this one out first. We should have had you join them first. Hi. Thank you. What's your name?
Lisa.
I've
just seen you on the Fox.
Good morning. Oh, my gosh. Yeah, yeah, that's so cool. Yeah, they are awesome, like, over there. Like, I love them.
Next
so,
to the wall?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Come over here.
Under the clock?
I'm next to the clock. Yes.
And you're on.
So, I'm here with Lisa. So, have you ever been bungee jumping, and why?
No, I have never been bungee jumping because I'm scared of heights.
Oh yeah, that would kind of be a problem.
Yeah.
Yeah. So would you ever go bungee jumping if you were dared to, and why?
No, I wouldn't. I would no.
Yeah.
No, because I'm afraid.
Yeah. I know. I'd be scared of that too. So what would you do if you went like? Okay. So what would you do if the bungee jumping like operator person, like the person like tells you to go and stuff? What if he was blind? Like, what would you do?
I still wouldn't go.
You still wouldn't
no,
go?
No. 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 I yeah. wouldn't. No. I wouldn't bungee jump.
Yeah. So like, how often would you go bungee jumping if someone paid you $1,000 per jump?
No, it'd have to be $1,000,000.
It'd have to be $1,000,000?
Yes.
And then how many times would you go?
Maybe once. Probably have a heart attack on the way down.
Oh, yeah. Well, if you lived, you got $1,000,000. Yeah. So, would you scream while you bungee jumped?
Yes. Oh, yeah, probably. Yeah, I think I'd pass out on my way down.
Yeah, cool. Well, thank you so much.
Oh, that's good. Oh, awesome. Yeah. I don't like interviews.
Yeah, that's fine. Thank you.
Thank you, and yeah. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Thank you, now.
You're welcome. Yes. Hi, what's your name?
Christian.
Okay, cool.
And you're on.
Hey.
Okay, cool. So I'm here with Christian. So, okay, would you ever do a Guinness World Record attempt for 24 hours?
That's a tough one. I don't know how you're doing it, but yeah, it's food, like my brother says. But yeah, I mean, I would try it. You got to do things, try it once in your life, but yeah.
I know, like YOLO, like why not? So what kind of record would you want to break for Guinness?
Jeez. That's a tough one. I guess some type of food record.
Yeah, like eating the most of, like, what kind of food?
Pizza.
Yeah.
Yeah, pizza pies. That would be a tough one, but I think, I don't know if I'll do it, but I'll try for 24 hours. Wow.
Yeah, like, do you know what the record would be, like, and how many you probably eat?
You know, what I can think about is the guys who do the Coney Island, you know, food challenge.
Yeah.
And they're eating those hot dogs in however long minutes, 2 minutes or whatever. So they do 42, but... I don't know. I really don't know what it could be for over 24 hours, but I can imagine a few pies.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I don't know how I would not be able to do that. I can have like one, maybe like 2 hours. So do you know like anyone else that has ever done a Guinness World Record?
No, actually you're the first person that I don't know anyone else because I don't know you.
That's fine.
But yeah, no, I don't know anyone else. And that's pretty cool.
Yeah, thank you. Okay. So what if you were like asked to do like the most push-ups? Do you think you could do it?
The most push-ups. Mm-hmm. Meaning the most push-ups in the world or the most push-ups that I can do right now?
Like in the world, like for Guinness.
Oh, hell no. Oh, hell no. Not at all. Not even close.
Yeah. Okay. So would you start a Guinness record if you could?
Start one? Yeah, why not? Yeah, put my name down on something, right? Yeah. Be a legend.
Definitely. Awesome. Cool. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're my pleasure.
Awesome.
Group photo right here.
Okay, cool.
Is it ready to take? I'm going to go horizontal with it, okay? Group photo.
Smile.
Here we go. Smile. Did it?
All right. Go. Sounds good. Thank you.
I mean, it looked like it did, but there's no noise.
I saw the action.
I saw it.
Okay, cool. Good. Thank you. Yeah, thank you.
You got to sign out. And who's next? This guy's next.
Hi. What's your name?
I'm John.
Okay, cool.
Yes,
nice to meet you. Yeah, nice to meet you too.
And we're on with John. Go a little closer.
So, oh, yeah, come over here.
Okay.
Okay.
And you're on.
So I'm here with John. So do you know how to fix your own car and, like, how?
I do. It depends what brakes. It could be anything in my car.
Yeah. Okay, awesome. So would you make a really good mechanic if you had to be a mechanic?
Probably not. I'm not that good. I could change a little minor things, but nothing worthwhile.
Yeah. So have you ever had to like change a tire on the side of the road or anything like that?
Plenty of times. Yeah. Oh yeah. Whenever they build new houses around here, developments or whatnot, I pick up nails every once in a while from time to time. Yeah.
That would be really, really bad. And actually, they're building a house where, like, near like where I live or whatever. That'd be really bad because I just got a car. So how often do you have to fix like a flat tire?
It's funny you say that. I actually just changed her mom's flat tire about a week ago.
Oh my gosh.
So it all depends, but yeah, it happens. It happens often, more often than you think.
Yeah, definitely. That's crazy. So describe like how you would deal with running out of gas on the highway. Like, would you freak out? Would you be totally fine? Or?
I hope my phone didn't die. Or so I'd call somebody. Mm-hmm. If I have my AAA card, I would call them, see if they could help.
Yeah.
Or try to flag someone down. Mm-hmm. I actually forgot to get gas on my motorcycle on the highway, or going over the bridge right here, Daytona Bridge, for Fort Orange Bridge, Dunlawton. And some guy stopped and gave me gas, thank goodness.
Oh my gosh.
And I got home.
That was so nice. Yeah. Oh my gosh, I would be like, what?
Yeah, I'm so happy.
Yeah. So what kind of car would you like to fix if you could?
I prefer not fixing any car.
Yeah.
But it'd be a Ferrari. That'd be cool.
Yeah, I fixed like the engine on there.
Something easy, because I probably couldn't fix anything on there.
Yeah, definitely. So if you could like drive like Jeff Gordon's car like, around town, would you be able to do that, and why?
Yeah, I could. It's fast.
Yes.
It'd be fun.
Yeah. Great. Cool. Thank you so much.
Oh, no problem.
Awesome. Great.
Excellent.
Whoops.
How are you?
That's Sophia's
mom.
What's
this date? 22nd.
Yeah, she's a girl. 11/16.
Would I give you some?
Here,
give
that to you.
Okay. Yes. No, sure, exactly.
Becky's not a weird name. What?
Okay. So yeah, you can just kind of go over it really quick.
Like
Samiqua or something. Or like Sparkle. I know someone who's Sparkle. Yeah. My name is Princess Gummy Buns. It's my adventure time. Oh, okay. Yeah. And then where
does it go? I'll just leave them here for now. Under there. Got a guy behind me.
Contacts are like dry enough on me.
Yeah.
Okay, here, I'll go on the side. What's your name, Daniel?
I'm Daniel.
Okay, cool. Nice to meet you.
All right, nice to meet you.
Yeah, and I'll take the car. Okay.
All right.
So, I'm here with Daniel. So, what's the strangest name someone introduced themselves like to you?
Pookie.
Pookie?
Yeah.
What? Were they like kidding or?
No, it was his nickname for something.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
That's crazy. What?
It was a one word answer.
Okay.
And why?
Yeah, so just make sure you expand on like, your answers and everything. Okay, so what's like the strangest name someone introduced themselves to you as?
Pookie. It was one of my friends. I just met him the first time. It was like, my name is Pookie. I was like, oh, really? Your name is Pookie?
Yeah.
It was funny. I was just that. That's how I told him. His name was Pookie.
Yeah. I would just be like, what? That's great. So was that their real name or was it just a nickname?
His real name was Brian.
Oh. How do you get Pookie from Brian?
I don't know. I guess it was a name somebody called him when he was younger. He just kept on and went with it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. That works. Mm-hmm. So did you ever like make fun of that name, or did you ever like let on?
I really don't know what a Pookie means, but it sounds like a dog's name, but we just called him Pookie. We just kept on. I didn't make fun of him.
Yeah. Okay.
People have strange nicknames these days, you know. Yeah. So just going with it.
Very true. Right. So what would you say if like they had like that was their real name, but it was like just strange like that?
Strange. I don't know. I won't probably be friends with him because that's a crazy name to have.
Yeah. You're yelling across the supermarket and
Pookie,
it's just like.
Yeah, you can want to yell Pookie out loud. Mm-hmm. People look at you and like, what's wrong with you, Pookie?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So would you laugh?
Maybe. I don't know. He's a close friend, so I don't know if I'll laugh at his face. Maybe I'll laugh behind his face or something.
Yeah, he doesn't need to know.
Yeah, he doesn't need to know.
Yeah. So do you ever think, like, if you had a strange name, like, you would keep it or would you change it, like, when you could?
I would change it because my name is Daniel. I like regular names. I don't like no crazy fake names like that. I just like learning name.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. And enjoy whatever you're doing.
Yes. Oh yeah, you'll be good.
Okay.
My phone kept vibrating. Okay, wait. Excellent.
Did you sign the release?
Yes, I did.
Very good. Yeah.
Oh wait. Okay.
Okay, no, I won't.
Okay.
Yeah, you give it to me. Okay. Okay, what's your first name?
Annette.
Okay, I knew that. Okay.
Yes. And Annette. No one-word answers. Just a little bit more.
A little bit more. Okay.
Yeah.
I'll do it.
Awesome.
And I'll walk a little closer to her.
Yeah. Okay.
So, and you're on.
I'm here with Annette. So, sorry. I just want to make sure we can all hear each other. So, how long do you think, like, about where? What? How long do you think about, like, where you're going to go about what you're doing that day?
Planning, probably it could be a day.
Yeah.
It could be, you know, depending if I'm getting ready for a weekend, or it depends if I'm getting ready for my business day.
Yeah.
If I'm business day, I pretty much at least a day in advance. If the weekend could be a half a day in advance.
It just kind of depends on
what I'm going to do or where I'm at.
That's awesome. Great. So if you only had like one t-shirt to wear, what kind of t-shirt would it be and why?
A t-shirt? I think one of these, the soft character t-shirts that are like really silky soft cotton, long sleeves.
Yes. Oh yeah, that sounds nice.
Yes. Yeah. Minnie Mouse on it would be good.
Oh yeah, that's really cute. Definitely. So home, So imagine you forgot your shoes like on your way to home or on your way to school or to work. Would you go back home to get them or would you just have to like go without?
I think I would go back home and get them, but then I might not leave home.
Yeah, I know.
Once I'm back there, I might decide to stay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. So describe the best day you've had at work this week.
Yesterday, Friday.
Really?
Yes. Had several activities during the day. I was getting work organized and getting ready for the weekend. Fridays is always good. TGIF.
I know, right? Friday's definitely the best. So if you miss the bus or like your car goes out of gas or something on your way to work, what would you do?
Start walking. And then start calling.
Yes.
Sorry. Cell phone and the feet going all at one time.
Yes. Get a hitchhiker ride from someone. Do you have like a nickname at like your workplace or anything like that?
Not that I know of.
Really?
No. I think some people call me Nat instead of Annette. But I've had some people call me Annie, but no real nickname.
Yeah. Cool. Well, thank you so much.
Well, thank you. Have a good time. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Perfect. And you're up. Okay, Bobby.
Yes. How are you?
Good.
Yeah, Sophia was just here.
Yes.
So, but yeah, okay, what's your first name?
Philip,
okay, cool. I'm here with Philip. So 11% of the world is left-handed. Do you know many people that are left-handed?
I know one, my mother.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, she's the only one I can think of offhand.
Oh, really? Yeah, my sister's left-handed, so that's kind of cool. Would it be easier or more difficult to be left-handed, and why?
It would be more difficult to be left-handed because many tools and instruments are really shaped for the right-handed folks.
True.
Since it's a higher number in the population.
Yeah, very true. I know, like, for scissors, like, when we're in school and everything, everyone's like, does anyone have, like, left-handed pairs?
Yeah.
So, that's definitely funny. Have you ever tried, like, practicing with your other hand? Like, oh, how does this hand write, you know?
Yes, I have tried to do that. In fact, I was in a class the other day, and that was one of the things we had to do was to try to write our signature with our left hand.
Oh, my gosh. That's, like, a hard requirement to, like, ask for.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. So, let's see, how would you manage if you had to write with your left hand?
Well, I would write slower and more carefully and maybe practice a little bit to try to get a little bit more skilled at it.
Yeah, definitely. It would take a little bit longer since you've had years with your right hand. So do you think left-hand people are smarter and why?
Well, I think that because the tools and things are all tuned toward the right-handed people, they have to be a little more creative in how they use those tools.
Yeah, true. Very true. That's awesome. Thank you so much.
All right. Well, thank you. Awesome. Good luck.
Good job. Oh, I'm starting to, like, Mike, my legs hurt. But
are you guys ready?
Yeah, are you guys ready?
No, you got your card? You got them on over the reach already?
Yeah, she took it.
Okay.
She has it over there. She has both of ours.
You pulled it out?
Yeah.
Perfect. Here we go.
Cool. What's your name?
Sarah.
Okay, cool. And just make sure you have, like, more than one word kind of answers. So, okay.
And you're on.
So, I'm here with Sarah. So, if you could only have, like, one meal for the rest of your life, what would that one meal be?
Steak and eggs.
Okay. Yeah, and why would... Okay, yeah, so just make sure you, like, what is it called? Expand on your answers and everything. So, I'm here with Sarah. So, if you could have one meal for the rest of your life, what would it be and why?
Steak and eggs, because that's what I grew up on. My dad always cooked, and he passed away in April.
Oh, yeah. That's a good, like, little memory. Yeah. So, what would you, what do you like most about that meal, like, and why?
It's just, I love steak.
Yeah.
And... I don't know, because I've always eaten it when I was little, and that's all my dad used to give us in the morning was steak and eggs.
Yeah, that's a cool, like, combo. So, let's see, what's the last thing that you've, what's the last thing you ate today, I guess, and why did you eat that?
It was Carolina barbecue chicken, and it was because it's my favorite kind of chicken.
Cool, awesome. So, would you eat, like, Cheerios, like, every single day if you could?
Honey Nut Cheerios, yes, I would, and because they're supposed to be healthy for you, and they're really good.
Yeah, they keep your cholesterol down or something like that.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, something like that. So what meal would you, like, totally avoid because it's, like, fattening or something, and why?
I don't eat turkey.
Okay.
I just don't like it. I don't like the taste of it. It's dry.
Yeah. So what are you gonna have for, like, this Thanksgiving, like, if you're not gonna have turkey?
Ham.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm a ham eater. Turkey is not my thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, totally. I'm vegetarian, so I don't like that either. So if you if you wanted a drink, like a milkshake to, like, gain weight, would you do that? Like, just, like, to gain a bunch of weight, drink a bunch of milkshakes?
Yes.
And, like, why?
Because I guess it would help you gain weight.
Yeah.
But I don't like milk, so.
Oh yeah.
It'd be a hard thing to try to do.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Can I just re-ask, like, the last question?
You could.
Okay. So, just, like, make sure you expand on the last one. So, if you wanted to drink milkshakes to gain weight, would you do that, and why?
Yes, I would. Because it would be healthy and supposed to be good for you.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Very good. Thank you. Me and your friend Sex.
Cool. In the pink jacket? Yeah. Thank you. What's your name?
Nicole.
Okay.
And your time was 11:27. Okay. Hang on and get a little closer.
Oh, yeah. Come a little closer over here.
And you're on.
I'm here with Nicole. So give me an example of a goal that you recently tried to reach and why.
I made a goal to move to Florida, and we moved to Florida.
Wow, look at that. How nice. Okay. How would you like to set your goals and why?
I like to set them a little bit lower so I don't, you know, get disappointed if I don't make them. But we try to reach for high goals.
Yes. Yeah, definitely. Was there ever a goal that you tried to make or tried to get and like you didn't make it, and why?
When I moved here, I wanted to be a cake decorator, and it didn't work out so well, so I just work on the deli.
Nice. Okay. You can still, like, try it out or something. Maybe
I get to write on cake sometimes, so it satisfies.
Yes. Yeah, definitely.
What is it? It just satisfies it. I miss doing it so much.
Oh, yeah. Mm. Maybe you could, like, work at, like, a bakery, and then, like, from there, like, make your own cakes.
Yeah, that's another goal of mine.
Yeah, that's great. So, when did you learn to really make goals and why?
Probably in kindergarten. I went to a private school and they taught you to set goals and to reach your goals.
Yeah, that's great. So do goals like sort of keep you like on target, like what you want to do?
They do. It helps us, and I'm trying to teach my girls to set goals too with everything that they do.
That's great. Cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Awesome.
Younger sister?
Yes.
I didn't catch the name.
Oh, Pavlina.
Jeffrey.
Hi. Nice.
Smart name.
Oh, yeah. So you can pick, like, one of these questions.
I got most of them over here.
Yeah, you have a bunch of them, but, like, here's some.
2 minutes. What question do you hate to answer?
Every
okay,
this question you're asking.
She just gave it to me.
What keys on a keyboard do you
use? What do I do with it?
Where's the rest?
Is this like a set of questions for 2 minutes, or is it like multiple cards?
No, just one card.
Wow.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
So I have to give a good answer for some of the last 2 minutes.
Yeah, I have those. Oh, you mean to keep them now?
See, the first question is, are you a good artist? I'd say, kind of artsy, like, video. Third question, painting.
Just make sure it's like a sentence for each one.
No short answers?
Yeah, no one-word answer.
That makes a lot harder to answer. I'm gonna make one card. Is it bad if it was longer than 2 minutes?
No, that's fine. Yeah, like, whatever.
Do you guys like Doctor Who?
I've never seen it.
No. Okay.
Here we go. You guys. Ready?
I've never seen it either.
What?
I'm not.
What?
He's
really?
He's before me though, so he's a longer.
No, you don't have to know the answers. It's okay.
I thought this
no,
was
Pavlina,
so wrong.
These are the last of the form. Where's the rest?
I thought that you said there were more in the folder.
These are all.
Then I don't know.
More?
I didn't print them. They did.
Okay.
But it's very
so,
official
yes, nice
because people have to, because Guinness has to prove, hey, this really did happen. You know? That's why we put it on video, but the video is never airing.
It's perfect.
Anywhere. Now, you already did one of these?
I already put out one this year.
Okay, good. Oh, wait, I'm going to do it. No, we can do it.
Do you friend? Does it matter the order?
The questions? Oh, no, not at all.
No, I meant like me and him.
No,
like,
no, it's okay. We try to keep them in similar.
What's the last Chinese dish you had? What's the last time you went on a fishing trip?
We can change screen a little bit if you want.
Hey, you said your name was Jeffrey?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, cool. Let's go over here.
Under the clock. Get a little closer to
her. I know, right?
Perfect. You're on.
Okay. So, hey, I'm here with Jeffrey. So, what's the last music video you watched with a friend and why?
It was an OK Go music video, and we watched it because it's that one continuous shot with a drone. And I work with drones and stuff, so I was really impressed.
Yeah, awesome. OK Go. Yeah, I know. It is really awesome. OK Good or OK Go, right, is what they're called? They're really, really cool. I saw one of their music videos like when they were on treadmills or something.
Yeah, they get creative. Exactly.
Yeah.
They're always really creative, so it's fun to watch.
Yeah, definitely. So what's like the last sport store that you've shopped in with a friend?
Maybe Sports Authority. But I was getting a Camelback for a music festival.
Nice.
So it's not really for sports, but it's for camping.
Yeah, that's very cool though. So what's like the last video game you played at like an arcade?
Arcade? Skee-ball. I love skee-ball. I could play that for hours.
Nice.
Me and this guy over here, we play skee-ball all the time.
Awesome, that's great. So what's like the last Chinese food that you had like as a carryout?
chicken lo mein. I could eat that every day, even when I'm sick. Chicken lo mein is the best.
Yeah. Nice. So, like, skee-ball and, like, what is it called? Turkey lo
Chicken lo mein.
Chicken lo mein. Okay, I'm getting my meats mixed up. So, when's the last time you went on a fishing trip?
Last summer in Wisconsin, we went out on the lakes, and it was awesome. Yeah. Woke up super early, drank a lot of beer. Yeah. It was very fun.
Yeah. Efficient day. That's cool. So, what's, like, the last scariest movie that you watched at home?
The Shining on Halloween, because The Shining is the best horror movie ever made. So I was very excited to watch that again.
Definitely. Cool. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It was fun to have me. Glad I could do this.
Yeah, thank you. Cool.
Okay. Is that 2 minutes?
Yeah, next. I guess.
Thank you.
It was around that time.
I was hoping it was going to be too fast. That's my main thing. I was like,
You would want to put 11:34.
All right. Yes.
And you're on.
So I'm here with Marcus. So what is your favorite string instrument?
My favorite string instrument is a guitar. Nice. Just electric guitar. I don't know.
Mine's like a violin. Like, I just love, like, listening to violins. So if you could play the violin, which is funny because I just said that, would you spend extra time, you know, time like trying to turn professional?
Probably not, since there's so many other types of things that I can do. I don't know. With stringed instruments, at least.
Yeah.
So many different kinds that you can learn from.
Yeah, definitely. So do you listen to any kind of classical music with violins, and why?
Yes, because it's sounds a lot better than most things that are out today, and more classical music's not dated for today. It's more dated back in the day.
Yeah, very true.
When music made sense. So.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know what we're doing nowadays with music. So, do you have any relatives that play any string instruments?
Yes, my uncle taught me how to play guitar, actually, so when I was 10 years old. I'm 21 now, so I've been playing guitar for about 11 years.
Great. Yeah, I know. It's just kind of like one of those things. Is playing the violin popular, like, at your school or workplace or not?
No, not really. I mean, it kind of was with music class in high school, but I never really had that class. I don't know. It was cool, though.
That's awesome. So what would you, Okay, so what would you do if someone gave you a violin and why?
I'd be stoked because violins are awesome. I'd actually really like to learn how to play them. If it's similar to playing a guitar, I guess.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
Except like with a bow.
Using the bow seems a little more difficult than.
Yeah.
I mean, Jimmy Page did it, so he did it with an electric guitar.
Yeah. Cool. Thank you so much.
Yeah. No problem.
Awesome.
Yep. Great job. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Oh,
and then I just need you to sign
So you're staying here till
9 a.m. or 9:30 tomorrow. Yeah. Wait, Sienna, how many people are we at?
I was like 260 something.
Oh really?
Yep. I think so.
So 260. How many? Cool. At least 291. No, 294, because like this record show needs to be 3, but we want like 300. So.
Oh, you told me 291.
Come back with like 6 more people later. I was gonna say our job is to finish this and come back with everyone for more beer. So
yeah,
bring a car, people.
Yes, I'd be good with that.
We'll be a little more sauced up later.
You guys have a good night, guys.
Good luck. All right, guys. Yep. We find out.
Oh, yeah, what?
No, Daddy's just making funny comments on how I'm not focused.
Oh.
You don't need to know.
I'm Larry's other daughter, Lauren.
Oh my gosh! Hi, nice to meet you.
So you get to pick your question.
Yeah, like whatever you want.
You can.
I don't like those pins because they're too thin.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I told him if he said it again, then I would just leave. Because that's unacceptable.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you agree, and then I would leave.
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
Doing very well.
I know some of them are crazy random. Which one is that?
Really?
Duck Dynasty.
Oh, yeah.
god, these are so funny. Wow. So you've already broken the record, right?
Not yet.
No, you're
no. Yeah, I have to get to 300. I think we're around.
But you
want to
like blow it out of the water,
yes.
Right?
Yeah. So if you know a bunch of people, bring them all down.
Yeah, I've been telling everybody.
Oh yeah.
And then I showed them the pictures, and of course everybody saw my dad, and they're like, "Oh, she's only got a red carpet."
Yeah.
Yeah. See, we're old, so we have to come to Walmart late when the kids go to bed. So I said she's gonna get a lot. Like it's still kind of early. You're gonna get a lot of crazy people.
I'm good. Yeah, crazy's always fun.
Thrift stores, that's a funny one too.
Good job. Your mom said we have to broadcast for 24 hours.
Yeah.
We don't have to.
I like this one.
That's right, I read
it's
it.
Me.
It can be anything in that broadcast. It doesn't have to be interviews, it could be anything in a broadcast.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
You good?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Are you good? So I'm here with Lauren. So yeah. So did you start going thrift store and like shopping after the song Macklemore, like Macklemore songs came out?
No, I have been shopping in thrift stores forever.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, same.
The best deals there. It's awesome.
I know. And like one of my friends actually, he found like a Versace tie or something out there. Like, and it was like nice and.
Oh yeah, they're awesome.
Yeah, definitely. That's really cool. So how many thrift stores have you been to?
I don't know. Hundreds.
Really?
Hundreds. I lived in New Jersey and Florida. I mean, I'm almost 30 years old. I've been to a lot of thrift stores. I can't even put a number on it.
That's crazy. So have you ever thought about starting like a thrift store of your own, like maybe for like a charity or something like that?
I could probably definitely start a thrift store of my own. I have a lot of stuff.
Yeah, definitely. And then what's the craziest thing that you've ever purchased at a thrift store?
Like brand new baby toys that are like $100 in the store with price tags still on them for like less than $5.
Oh my goodness. That's
yeah.
crazy.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Halloween costumes, are they good to like buy at used stores because like, you know, they're like dyed and all this other stuff or?
I mean, it depends on what you buy. You can get like a lot of good accessory pieces to go with your costume, but. I mean, you can find a whole costume there. I mean, it's been done, definitely.
Yeah. What is, like, the best thrift store you've been to in Florida?
There's actually a really good one here, Goodwill in Port Orange.
Oh. Okay.
It's really good.
Yeah.
You can get a lot of good things there.
Awesome. That's great. So would you ever get, like, a Halloween costume from there? Like, a straight up the whole Halloween costume?
I mean, if I could find it, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, definitely. That's great. So, okay. Let's see. Do you go to like groups to purchase Halloween stuff, or like do you just go like would you go in groups to go like thrift store shopping like to get Halloween stuff, or by yourself?
With my family because we all dress up together.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's great. Cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Nice.
You're welcome.
Well, good luck. It was nice to meet you.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you. 11:42. I would. I don't make coffee, but I will tonight. You know, it's kind of safe.
What time is it?
It is 11:42. Thank you for doing that. That was very good, by the way.
Yeah, I got it.
I do thrift stores, too.
Some of those questions, like...
You live in Daytona?
No, I live here in Port Orange.
They have a thrift store in Daytona. Tuesdays. 50% off.
Nice.
Like Kansas City Thrift or something?
Oh, yeah, they're great. There's one right here that saves the animal store on Monday. All their clothes are 50% off.
Really? That's in Port Orange?
Yes.
Where?
Right here, you know where the old people lot used to be?
No.
Sorry. It's in there now. If you made your parties across from the
cafe. Oh, yeah, over there.
Yep.
That little strip mall.
Yep. Yep.
Thank you. It was nice to meet you.
Do another one?
Yep.
Here, Growing up.
Okay, what's your name?
Linda Clay.
Okay. So just give me like sentence answers, okay? So like more than one word.
Like yes or no?
No, yes or no. Like explain everything. So Linda? Right? Okay.
She didn't fill one out? Yeah.
She can do that afterwards?
Yeah, we can do that after here, you go.
So.
And ma'am?
Oh, yeah.
Against the wall a little bit there. Mm-hmm. There you go.
Yeah.
Perfect. And get ready. And you're on.
I'm here with Linda. So what's like the best compliment you've ever received?
And why?
The best compliment? Thank you for for the food.
Oh yeah, for like someone if you've prepared food before.
No, see, I usually give food to the neighbors that you know, the sick people or whatever, or the older people.
Mm-hmm. That's great. That's really nice. So was this a compliment like from like a relative? Like, do your relatives ever compliment you?
Yes. They sent me a Kindle for Christmas.
Oh, wow. Nice. That's really nice.
Good relatives. That's good. So how does this make you feel when you get compliments?
Makes me feel good.
Mm-hmm.
It makes me want to encourage them too.
Yeah, definitely. To like give compliments and stuff. So do you get compliments from people often?
Sometimes. I can't think right now. My brain's not working too good. So I get compliments often and why? When I do reports, I'm a Sunday school secretary.
Yeah.
And he said he always likes the way I type it.
Yeah.
Because it comes out all right. Mm-hmm. Neat.
Yeah, definitely. It's always good to
neatness. Be like
that. Yes, neatness is always good. If someone compliments you, do you usually say thank you or like what do you normally say?
Thank you and God bless you.
Awesome. Okay. And then how much does it like mean to you when people say that you look nice or that you're nice? And that's what Guinness
then verifies. Thank you for the compliment and I tell them where I got the clothes or whatever.
Yeah, perfect. Cool. Thank you so much.
That's it?
Yep, that's it.
Oh, thank you.
Yes.
What was the question?
Oh, this was for the radio program?
Yes. Oh, she's going to do
it. What's the station?
She needs a blank one. That one first. Well, she can sign that one.
91.5.
There's a time on that.
Yeah, that's the one that I listen to. I really like it.
Yeah,
because I just got a new car and I'm not used to it.
Oh, yeah.
And so I found the station and I really like it.
Yeah.
What nationality is that?
Yeah. Yeah. A little bit of paperwork for you. And print your name. 11:52 was your time. And then sign that. And you have a monitor here as well. Got a flight there?
I worked for ACJB. It was a radio down in Ecuador.
Oh, yeah.
Well, they're mostly radio, but I was working on the radio. I was on the radio down there.
This needs an Ormond Beach on here. Is he still here?
Who, the gentleman?
Was right there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, I have an official Guinness Book of World Records.
Record. Sticker code. Okay. Just take this over to him and John. Fine.
could you stop?
Could be above it or below it. So I believe that's the one that needs. Capistrano, he looks like Capistrano.
It's all her. It's all this little bunch of shit. Like, I, you know, if I want to go home, I can go.
They don't know.
Capistrano, Ormond Beach, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I live up there.
So, okay, please.
Pavlina's kids' place. I came over there.
Oh, no.
Okay, so you got
this one. So you work with kids?
Yeah, well, like, I was 11 when I created it, so it's like my kids' thing.
We were supposed to do that first, but we didn't. Did you do one, Bob?
Yes, he did.
Yeah.
He just
needs to sign up. Yeah, you can. Sit right in my seat. That's the key. I don't blame you. Do you want something?
Do you
want some peanuts?
Yeah, you got some?
These are unsalted. You can have all you want. I love them. I keep them right here.
Are we good?
Yep, here we go. And pull them in.
Okay. Oh, yeah, come a little closer over here. So I'm here with Josh. So Ghostbusters was like a really cool movie in the 1980s. Have you watched it lately, and why?
I have, because it's a classic.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I love Ghostbusters. Exactly. Like, go, 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 Busters. So at Universal Studios in Orlando, they have like a lot of Ghostbusters like merchandise and everything. Did you ever buy, like, would you ever buy any like Ghostbusters merchandise like the last time you were at Universal Studios, and why?
I would, for nostalgia reasons, for my kid, you know, bringing back to my childhood.
Yeah, definitely, that's great. Okay, and then the puffy, like, cute ghosts, like, are they, or like, okay, so puffy cute ghosts or like the scary ones, and why?
Definitely the scary ones. I mean, just to frighten people, that's what they're for, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly, okay. And then what was like the last ghost movie that you saw, and why?
The Conjuring, because I heard it was a really good movie and it was really scary.
Yeah, definitely. You saw it on Halloween?
Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome. So what if like you saw a real ghost while you were shopping, what would you do?
Probably do a double take and then keep it moving.
Yeah. Run away.
Right.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Not a problem. Thank you.
No, you can't. It's not at all. If it'll fit. Some people have really long ones. Isn't that great? You better enjoy it now. Winter's coming, isn't it?
Tuesday, it did come.
Okay.
Awesome.
I have to wait for him.
Okay.
How you doing? Yeah. It's getting late. Do you normally come to Walmart like when it's...
No, I got done with work late.
Oh, really?
So
yeah.
I got wine and a pizza.
Oh, we're going to do something?
Nice. Yeah.
Are you ready? Pull her
yeah.
in there.
Oh, yeah. Come closer over here.
Is it the 22nd or the 23rd?
22nd still.
Okay.
It's cold. Okay. I'm here with Hannah. So if you have blue eyes, you actually have a higher tolerance to alcohol, like alcohol tolerance, I guess. So do you wish you had or do you have blue eyes?
I do have blue eyes, and I don't think that I have a higher alcohol tolerance.
Yeah.
Definitely not.
Okay. And then all like blue-eyed people like can trace back to one person who lived near like the Black Sea almost like 10,000 years ago. So that's kind of cool. Do you ever wish you could travel to the Black Sea?
Not really. I've never really thought of that as a travel destination.
Yeah.
So okay. Maybe in the future.
There you go, Matt. Now you can probably think of that. So how many nicknames do you get like because of your eye color? Do you ever? Is that ever a thing?
Never. Mm-mm. Not once.
Yeah. Okay. Awesome. So contact lenses, you know, really can like change your eye color sometimes. I know some people with like crazy eye colors. So would you ever change your eye color to like purple or something like that?
No, I like mine. Yeah. It's a pretty good color.
Yeah, definitely. So what if you, like, okay, so have you ever wanted to have, like, just better vision? Like, do you have to use contacts or glasses?
No, I have a 20/20, so it's pretty nice.
Yeah.
Not having
you
to
have
worry
the good
that.
Life. I have contacts, like, shriveling up on me right now. So what if you had, like, x-ray vision, like, as a superpower? Would you do that, and why?
X-ray vision?
Yeah.
Oh, no. I don't think that would be a very good idea. I just a lot of personal things going on. I don't know if I want to see behind any curtains or anything like that. So X-ray vision probably not would be my choice of superpower.
Okay, there you go. Thank you so much for talking to me.
Thank you. Good luck.
Thank you.
Guys next? Are you guys next?
Yeah, he's next. Good.
Oh.
Are you giving away cash?
Yeah, no problem. Every person that did this sign, they donate a key into the show. I wish I had loose one, but I'd give you one. There you go.
Okay.
You got two guys in a row.
I'm good. How are you?
Against the wall.
So, can you tell me your first name?
Jeff.
There you go. Very nice. You're done. Okay. Just kidding. So, I'm here with Jeff. So, did you have a lot of sugar today? Like, cereal, donuts?
I had some donuts this morning and a pumpkin spice cheesecake muffin.
Oh, my gosh. That's, like, intense. Wow, look at that. So, what candy bar do you, like, always reach for when you're at, like, the checkout counter, and why?
You know, when I get to the ticket, I like to mix it up.
Yeah.
I like to mix it up, but you know, I never have any one. I always go for Snickers, Butterfingers, Baby Ruth, Reese's, anything.
Oh yeah, Baby Ruth, that's like my thing. There you go.
There you go.
Yeah. So if you had a choice of like flowers or chocolate as a gift, which one would you choose and why?
Well, I think I'd have to go with the chocolate because I got a sweet tooth.
Yeah, definitely. Same. So how many times a day do you go for like something sweet?
How many times a day? Just as often as, I guess, whenever I get the craving, when I get that sweet craving.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. And then what dessert do you like best?
My favorite dessert is probably tiramisu.
Oh, yeah. Nice. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's see, do you think you have a sweet tooth? Like, I know you were kind of saying that earlier, but, like, why do you think you have, like, such a big sweet tooth?
Because when I get that craving, I gotta have it.
Yeah.
I just gotta go and get it.
Cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you, Pablo. Yeah,
that's my adopted son. That's my baby brother, too.
If you get in there, I'll take your picture.
I'd love you for that.
You don't have to do this.
He says, it's okay,
no love. Come on, Papa Bear. Okay.
Sonria, aquí.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you. It was awesome.
There's either dirt on them or...
It's okay. Is it?
Yes. Because the color is all weird.
I can play with it.
Right. It's all funny.
Something wrong.
Wrong.
I can add something to it.
Oh, Starbucks.
There's something wrong with that.
What is life?
How do you
feel
doing? Oh, is there one more guy here? Is the other guy ready? Before I go to radio?
Give him
3 minutes,
please.
We gotta make sure we get this right. This is scary. I mean, for the rest of the 24 hours. Does Jason know this?
Yeah.
He's gotta do. Okay, good. He understood that this is 24 hours and it keeps having little plugs to the show. Because we can be off for 5 hours.
I know. He already recorded her 2 pieces that all she recorded last night.
And he last night. And he knows.
Well, I can't answer that he knows. I can tell you what he's told me. Because I can't know what's in his head.
No, I understand.
I just, being clear, I mean, right. I don't know that he knows. I know that he called me this morning and said that he recorded and put in place her bumps that she recorded last night. Okay. That would tell me.
Before he went to sleep, I texted him that we're still going. First, I thought we would be done. And he said, let me know, because I'll go to music. We're allowed to have music.
It's midnight.
Right. We're allowed to have it.
Diet. texting him or what?
Good. Yeah, he's out. God, my phone is not charging. Very good. Bad connection.
Oh, or like, Douglas, do you guys want coffee or anything?
No, thank you. I'm not a coffee drinker.
I'm not either, but you know what? I'll drink one. I'll drink anything you got at this point. Okay, so.
So are we doing the final interview, or?
No.
Yeah,
she's going to do it.
And then we'll come back later.
So we are only about 18 away.
I know.
And it being midnight, it's kind of funny. I think there'll be another late night burst as the clubs start closing.
Correct. People going home. I'm going shopping. I'm tired of going out.
Because the funny thing is...
Are we done with this guy?
Yeah.
Yes.
There's one more guy?
No. He's coming back.
Okay, good. Well, then we'll wait.
So I'm going to go to radio.
No, not yet, because he's coming back with a couple of people.
Right now?
Yes, right now. He went to the parking lot.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You order a coffee?
Burger King's closed.
McDonald's is open.
For what kind?
I have a wall plug and.
Oh, if you've got a wall plug, we've got power.
Yeah, it's the kind of disconnect.
We should be good.
Charger, please.
Take me to your charger. It's right over here in the corner.
Oh, like, why can't he stay with me?
Oh, yeah, here.
Because I'm still texting.
You're still working? You mean your work?
You're tethered.
Yes.
You gotta get a chair.
Oh,
she says I'm tethered to it. Imagine that. See, that's the way it was in the old days. With a wall phone.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I remember those.
Here, I have a rock to sit on.
Okay, that's fine. Yes, like this right there.
Back in the days of war.
Let me flip it over. Watch this. There's a hard one. Better on your tush.
Yeah. Okay.
Because you don't have a lot of meat on those.
Oh, yeah, that feels good. That lean on the lower back feels good. Hi, guys. Would you like to help us set a world record tonight?
Are you sure? We're so close.
Oh yeah, what's the
most interviews conducted in 24 hours? Because I sat down. Damn it.
But you did get their attention.
I know, really? What? I know, right?
Have you seen him now? He's all skinny and everything.
Okay.
Big boat in the water or in the farm?
Should be good.
How can you eat those peanuts? They have nothing on them.
They have nothing. You're right.
They're literally dry.
They're like eating. It's like a mouthful of peanut butter.
Yeah, he's very happy.
Thank you, you're actually right. They're horrible.
Yeah. Like, not bad.
I'm kind of a mixed nut fan.
Yeah, same. Like, I like my trail mix. I like, what's it called? I like it when they're, like, so good. You know, like, they have a bunch of, like, cinnamon or something crazy on them.
No,
you
guys
give me a point.
It's beyond pasty.
I took like one handful or whatever, and I was like, oh, okay.
The manager inside is very, very friendly to us. He's been sending people out to us when they're on break.
Okay, that's really
So what's our count now?
What?
What's our count?
273. Now, I thought the record to be was... I thought the record was 291.
That's what I thought too. Your mom corrected me and said 292.
We lost the chairs.
Where?
No, I guess we don't.
No, we don't. The green one and the blue one.
Right.
Welcome to share a spot here.
No, I'm okay. I could show you right here. Okay, we're going to go to radio, except that guy's coming up. We'll go to radio.
I like what you recorded, Beth. With your pre-records. Now, should she do... I know you put the, I mean those bumps we did last night.
Oh, yeah. What? No, I had to do,
A term goes to shows.
Like, quick little, like, drops, or whatever.
Basically, it said, you're listening to Paulina try to set a Guinness World Record. Stay tuned while you listen to a little bit of music while we try and go out and find a few more people to interview. So that whenever we went to music, it was playing that along with songs. And it makes it sound very professionally produced with very little effort. Yeah, that's the key question, is what do we do for the next
time? Are you tired? No.
I'm not really.
After 12, it starts all over again.
I mean, I'm a night owl. Yeah. Staying up all night for me on projects doesn't faze me.
Like, I like sleep, but I like sleep.
But I will say that after running around all week, I'm looking forward to sleep.
Yeah.
Because I didn't sleep much this week. It is true. I mean, it's funny that we have to literally, like, turn around while we're saying, it's an official attempt, see?
Yeah.
And then they go, oh! Yeah. With him carrying the little one, I feel a little hesitant, but...
Yeah, they're not stopping.
Right. Hi, guys.
Yeah, go freshen up, would you?
Okay. Freshen, all good stuff. Do you want anything
else?
Beer.
Sir, are you willing to try and help us set a world record tonight?
Excellent choice. I'll break the camera, see?
You wouldn't
break
it.
No, it's okay. Yeah, it'll be super quick.
Right,
five questions.
I would break that camera.
Nope, I haven't broken it yet, so you can't either. Yeah, it's okay. Come over here. We have 5 quick questions, like, to help break again this world record. We're almost there.
We're only about a
17-year-old girl is trying to get a world record.
Is it?
Yep. Yes.
And we're really close.
We're about 18 away.
Yeah.
We
really?
Need every
That's why
person.
We're sitting here till we're done. And you guys are allowed to go on camera, they said.
Yes. Super quick. You get to, like, pick your questions.
No, they didn't say anything.
It takes about 4 minutes.
Less you're than 4 minutes, actually. Camera. It takes like 20 minutes.
That's true. If you're good, 2 minutes.
Really quick.
He's good. Listen to him.
Really quickly. It's like midnight right now.
They're not gonna let me go on there in Walmart.
I've interviewed some of the Walmart employees.
They said they just take the I told them no they couldn't. Usually they don't. They had a meeting and told them at the meeting that yes they could do it. We've had about 5 or 8.
Sir, are you interested in helping us break a world record tonight?
Nah.
You're like, we went this long and
then... You'll get broken again some other time.
Oh, that's
a little girl's dream.
I got to get them to tell me it's okay.
I will be right back. I'm just going to run for Lance. 12:10.
Yep. I expect to see you at 12:15.
That's 5 minutes.
Yeah.
That's not possible.
All
right, I will be right back. Do you want anything?
Yeah, I was kind of planning.
Do you want monster drinks?
No, I have
to take naps and then come back. But I mean, the program has to go on.
Yeah.
And even if it just
once an hour laying in there or something, you know what I mean? Which is what we're going to get. Because there'll be people coming out after the bars, you're right. They're going to go, ooh, wow, that's cool, I'll do it. They're going to see her.
Yeah.
Excellent choice. Is your buddy coming out too, yeah?
He's really not into this, but I can believe that.
Thank you. It'll really help.
And I mean, it.
Yeah, we're about to get a world record.
We're very close to the record, though. Thank you, by the way.
Good choice, buddy.
And we're literally within striking distance. Isn't that crazy? Kids at Walmart are just crazy. Sometimes that makes me feel like we're shooting porn. It's just on radio. This will never be seen anywhere.
Gotta be a kicked ass.
What's that?
You kicked ass and then you just died. Swap your batteries real quick.
For what?
I'm just controlling the microphone.
You shouldn't have given me this many choices.
I didn't want you to be back. I got coffee.
That's okay. No, I didn't want it. I don't drink coffee. Can I help you hold some of this?
Yeah, that's for
coffee. Oh, I got one too. My first coffee in 20 years.
It's all yours, big guy. Yes, she
did. Is that coffee really?
Okay. Yes, it is.
Just random.
And he did say you had it.
Okay.
I'm going to swap your batteries.
I don't know that I need any.
Okay, so you can do really good?
Yeah, sure. Swap your batteries.
What? Okay.
Ask them to do it too. Come on, folks. You can help us break this record right now if you'll come over and help.
That's true. We're that close.
We are that close.
Okay.
When do you have
to? Until 9 tomorrow. So if you have like, we started at 9 a.m. today, so like, or 9:30 today, and then 9:30.
Would it really help?
Okay.
What is that?
It's just the radio coming back here. Here we go. We're on.
But like, what's going? What's doing that sound?
Your laptop. Now, what I'd like to find is I've not been able to find it.
Okay, we're good. That was weird. That was really. What's your name?
Chris.
Okay, cool. So, we good?
Let me hear you a little bit. We're not rolling. Let me hear you.
Oh, hi. Check.
And you're on.
Okay. I'm here with Chris. So, okay, you woke up, like, today, like, or tomorrow or whatever, and you're on a bus with Ariana Grande. What would you do and why?
Ask her why she chose singing.
Okay. Well, yeah.
Because I have no idea why someone would go into that business.
Yeah, okay, that works. So what would you, like, would you ever sing with her on stage and why?
No, because music has lost its luster over the years, and rock and roll is where it's at.
Yeah, like the Rolling Stones?
Yes, like the Rolling Stones.
Very nice, okay. And then if you had to write, like, a song for her, what would you, like, probably write about and why?
I would write about food. because food is great and yeah. everybody needs food, like pudding cups. Pudding cups are good. Life's tough without a pudding cup.
Yeah, true. It is very true. Vanilla or chocolate?
Chocolate.
Yeah. Same. Like, the vanilla is just kind of weird. It tastes like rubber or something. So who's the biggest celebrity you have ever met and why?
Ever met? Like, personally? Rhea Perlman from the sitcom Cheers. She's the only celebrity I've ever met, and it was at the Chicago Art Museum.
Wow, look at that. Yeah. Okay. Cool. And then, okay, so what would you say to, like, what would you say to that person when you met him at the museum?
I just said, hi, are you Rhea Perlman from Cheers? And she said yes, and I'm like, okay, that's cool.
Yeah. Nice. There you go. That's short and sweet. What would you do, like, if you got to meet up with her again?
I asked to have a beer with her.
Yeah, okay.
Because it just would be ironic because yeah. the show.
But. Yeah, definitely. Cool. Thank you so much.
All right, no problem.
Thank you. And then if you can, like, log out really quick right there.
Print your name on the left. Put the sign.
And then here is an official Guinness sticker.
Oh, awesome sauce.
Yeah, okay. So,
all right.
Okay, and then I'll take the questions.
Okay.
Okay, so what's your first name?
Tatiana.
Okay, yeah. Awesome.
Okay.
Cool. Okay. Yes, turn on the camera.
All right.
Okay, we good?
And four close.
Oh, yeah, if you can, like, come close over here.
Okay.
And you're on.
So I'm here with Tatiana. So New York, keeps their train tracks, like, free of, you know, ice and any kind, like, so, like, so they don't sit on fire, basically. have you ever seen the tracks set on fire, and why?
No. I haven't seen any tracks on fire. I mean, I want to hope I see train tracks on fire.
Yeah, that would be kind of scary. I don't know what I would do. I'd just be like, I'm not going to go on this train. How often do you see, like, trains in New York, or do you go on trains in New York?
I've never been on a train in New York. I've been on a subway in New York, but not a train. But I do, when I do go to New York, I do see trains pretty often.
Yeah. Definitely. Awesome. So, would you, like, ever want to go, like, in a trolley crane or, like, a really empty crane?
Or a train. I'm not saying crane. Ooh, I don't know. I'd be scared to go on an empty train, but I'd probably go on an empty train. Mm-hmm. Not too empty, though, because it's scary, but, yeah. Not too many people on the train, no.
Yeah, like a small amount, maybe.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's not too crowded to where you, like, are standing only
exactly.
kind of thing.
Yeah.
But then, like, not empty, so it's, like, not
creepy.
Some,
yeah.
I'm just sitting here. So have you ever been delayed, like, while waiting on a train?
No. I've never really been on a train. But on a subway, no, I haven't been delayed either.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Awesome. Okay. And then do trains, like, usually run on time, or are they usually late?
I would think they run on time. I mean... Yeah, but they run on time.
Yeah. Awesome. And then what if you had to, like, ride in a train every day to go to work? Would, like, the job be worth it for that?
It would, because you're saving gas. So,
yeah,
it'd be good transportation to go to work. So.
Yeah, definitely.
It'd be worth it.
Yeah. Cool, thank you.
You're welcome.
Cool. And then could I get you to, like, sign out really quick, like, right over here? And you get an official sticker. That's awesome. What time is it? Oh, I know, right?
How long are you guys out here?
Until 9:30 tomorrow morning.
Oh my goodness.
So you can just send, like, all of your friends over.
Wait, what's
that?
Yeah.
24. Is your mom done
with you? Oh, what?
Is your mom done?
No.
Thank you.
She's yeah, thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Mom,
you're
up.
Is that? Is that yours?
I don't know. Do you want it?
I did one. I'll take the ice cup. Everybody has
sugar. Well, one's in the Sienna.
No, Sienna doesn't want one.
Your next two coming up.
This gentleman's next right now. Okay.
Okay.
Just finish
signing up.
All right. Let me show you what you're doing first. What is that line? What?
Cool. And then, do you want to, like, just grab, like, a random question?
Sure.
Okay. Cool. And what's your name?
Brandon.
Okay, cool.
Check his mono release first. Sure, so we know that. And let me hear you.
Check.
And you're on.
You said Brandon, right?
Yes.
Okay. I'm here with Brandon. So if you had, like, to go to a birthday party this week, whose birthday party would it be? Like, a celebrity, one of your friends?
It'd probably be Cole Stout, celebrity.
Yeah. That's very cool. Yeah. Nice. What kind of present would you bring them and why?
I'd probably bring them a new set of shoulder pads or gloves or something.
Yeah. Something like that. Yeah. Awesome. Okay, so if the party like turned out to be like, really boring, would you leave early and why?
If it turned out to be really boring, I would probably leave early. Yeah. Because he can get boring sometimes.
Yeah.
But other than that, he's a pretty cool guy. So I don't know. I might stick around. Yeah. But
just to hang out with him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome. Okay. So what if like the birthday person like sibling was like Ed Sheeran or something? Would you have to like stay a little bit longer just because Ed Sheeran's there? Or
no. I wouldn't, no.
No?
No.
Awesome. And then how would you react if you were around celebrities, like, all over the place at the birthday party? And, like, why?
You know, if there were a bunch of celebrities there, might be a little nerve-wracking. But there probably wouldn't be a lot of celebrities because he's not that famous.
Yeah.
But it would be nerve-wracking if it were a bunch of celebrities with him. So.
Yeah. Definitely. Yeah. Cool. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Awesome. Cool. And then if you can fill out this last paperwork right here, and here is a Guinness sticker.
12:26 a.m.
Thank you. Hi. What's your name?
Chris.
Okay. Awesome. Oh yeah. Shaking you the wrong hand. Okay. Let's go over here.
And you're on. Go against the wall.
Oh yeah. Yeah, a little bit closer to, like, the clock and stuff. So I'm here with Chris. So when you watch Star Wars, like, who was your favorite character and the one you remembered the most?
It would probably be Boba Fett.
Yeah.
Boba Fett's the one I remember the most.
Yeah, definitely. That was my brother's favorite. He had, like, the helmet and, like, everything. So where were you when you first saw the Star Wars, the first Star Wars film?
I was at home with my family. You know, they really love the Star Wars trilogy, so... Mm-hmm. We all checked it out together.
Yes, definitely. Yeah. I love Star Wars. That's great. So what room would you decorate like total Star Wars design?
Oh, definitely my my study room. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I would put up posters all over the walls and just really relax me in between studying.
Yeah, just deck it out. Awesome. So when is like the last time that you thought like Darth Vader was like a bad villain?
Honestly, when I was young, I always thought he was bad up until, obviously, Return of the Jedi.
Yeah.
But, you know, as I got older and started watching him over and over again, I was like, man, you know, Darth Vader really wasn't that bad a guy all through the second movie, Empire Strikes Back. You know, you started seeing him kind of come out of it. So.
Yeah, definitely. That's very cool. You know, you get to see the other side of Darth Vader. So if you had to put yourself, like, on a deserted island with a Star Wars character, who would it be and why?
Probably be Leia. Yeah. And I'd rather not say.
Yeah. Okay. Awesome. And who would be like the hottest person in the Star Wars thing?
Hottest person? Mm-hmm. No, Chewbacca.
Chewbacca?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of hair. Oh. So
yeah, definitely. Cool. Thank you so much. Yes,
absolutely.
Awesome. Cool. Thank you. And then if you can like fill out this last paperwork really quick. Thank you, Fiona. And then here is an official sticker.
Impressive. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, you won't try. You gotta cut it.
Yeah.
So it's like, could you come over here? Yeah, you can come on this side. It's like almost like 1:30, I guess, or
12:30. Your best friend, be easy, okay?
Yes, okay. Sounds good. What's your first name?
Ziad.
What is it?
Ziad.
Ziad? Okay, cool. So I'm here with Ziad. So, okay, so you're walking home in the dark, and, like, you see something move. What would you do and why?
I will keep walking and pay attention to the moving thing, but I will keep walking. I'm not going to be scared.
Man, I would be freaking out. I don't know what you're talking about. I'd be like, start running. How often do you walk in the dark and why?
I don't think so that often, but sometimes I walk in the dark.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like whenever you need to, I guess. So do you think it's like scary or is it okay to like be alone, like be by yourself when you're in the dark?
No, it's okay. I like usually to walk in the dark on the beach.
Yeah.
Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah, that must be like really relaxing. So how often do you go walking in the dark? And why?
Once a week, mm-hmm. twice a week, always on the beach. I like to be relaxing when I walk in the dark.
That's awesome. That's great. So is it safer to walk in the dark like now or like 50 years ago, or is there like no difference?
No, this is, of course it's different, yeah, because the stress of the life nowadays is different than 50 years ago.
Yeah.
So of course it's different.
Yeah, definitely. Cool, awesome. And then, so does your parents or like does someone have to tell you not to walk in the dark? Like, has anyone ever been like, no, don't do that, or it's like whatever?
Of course, my mom, she always tell me, don't walk in the dark. Yeah. Mom's is always mom. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Oh, add one? Okay. Yeah, yeah. Have you ever, like, when you were, like, a kid, were you ever afraid of the dark?
Yeah, of course. When I was a kid, I was afraid of the dark. But when you grow up, you know, yeah, I don't think so. I'm afraid now from the dark.
Yeah. Yeah. Awesome. Well, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Awesome. Thank you.
Oh, yeah, we're good. Oh, you went. Okay.
Yeah, you don't want, yeah. Thanks, boo.
Awesome.
There's something cool. wrong with your camera. Just so you know.
And here is an official Guinness sticker.
Time?
Oh, it's like 12:32.
I don't like looking at that thing.
Yeah, I know. And then your signature? It's not 12:27. The 6 is a 30. Oh. You're just a little tired. Did that other guy fill out one of these?
His watch is wood. I've seen that.
Oh my gosh.
Hold on, wait.
Excellent. Two of those questions were so similar, that's why I did it.
Oh, okay. And then, did you want to pick out like a question?
I'm
going to
go put this in the car.
Yeah. Okay, that sounds good. Which coffee did you want to get? You don't want coffee?
I haven't had coffee in 25 years.
Really? How do you survive? Jeez.
Tea in 25 years.
Yeah. Easily, probably 35.
Oh, really?
I had an ice cream.
Yeah. Fiona, which one do you want?
I don't know.
Then
I
have like, a sip of that. Give me the other like one before it goes bad or something. Just give it to me. Can you put like a napkin on it?
This is what.
Yeah.
Can do this.
Get rid of the this drop. Yeah.
Wait, this is written by me.
Of course.
Thank you, Dad.
Do you have a napkin?
It's kind of hard to see that.
No. I don't write. Yes.
But I'll tell you again, it's not going to.
It's just for like, again, it's to know that you're not like a robot or like we didn't just make you up or something.
But you're absolutely right. Very smart. Very sick. And that is a standard model. Okay.
Hello. I'll do it.
I did add some stuff too there because I'm a photographer. And I really like that.
Tell you what.
But I don't do that.
If this comes back any other type of way, because mine
is. You're going to come look me up.
Oh, trust me.
I know.
Is it good? Okay, make sure you drink it.
I am going to law school.
That's good.
Oh, my sister's a lawyer.
Really? Yeah. And I'll hurt you.
Oh, my gosh. Where's Sienna when we
meet? Yeah.
She actually. The 22nd.
23rd.
No. Oh, it is the 23rd now. You can make up an address.
Oh my gosh. It is so cool.
Do you know what happens in the middle of the night at Walmart? Now you know.
Yeah.
We clean the streets. Oh, awesome. Yeah. You pick one of those. And have him sign this really quick. Yes. So have him sign one of those.
Good for you to be going and doing law. You'll do well with that.
My sister literally just left. She just freshened up and stuff, but she's in law school.
Oh,
so.
Which law school
is
she going to?
Stetson in Tampa.
Oh, I was thinking about going to that one. I wasn't sure, though. Did I need to sign that, too?
No, that's like afterwards, yeah, and you get a sticker, too.
Okay,
so.
Yeah, let me get this to my boyfriend.
Okay, cool. Wait, here, hold this really quick, Fiona. Your first name?
Jessica.
Awesome. I was waiting for him to turn the camera on. Check, check, check. I'm here with, okay, oh yeah, come over here. So I'm here with Jessica. So what do you like most about public speaking and why?
Public speaking, you're able to get your voice out and get to, you know, see how you are in front of the camera and how people view you.
Yeah, exactly. That's a good point. So if you had to speak today, like, in front of a crowd of people, would you and why?
Probably not, but if I have to, I'd probably talk about, what's going on with our youth.
Yeah.
And how we're being brainwashed to do things that we really shouldn't.
Yeah, definitely. So what would you like to talk about in front of a group of people that, like, that you know, like, a lot of them?
If I had a group of people in front of me and I knew a lot, I'd probably talk about what's going on in government as far as politics and getting out there and voting and actually making a difference.
Yeah, I know. I'm so excited because, like, the next presidential, like, election or whatever that's coming up, I'll finally be 18 so I can, like, vote and stuff. I'm so pumped.
Yeah, that's very exciting. I hope you do vote.
Yeah, I will. And I'll tell my friends to vote and stuff. So how often do you, like, give speeches at, like, work or at school?
I really don't give speeches, but I do talk to people in customer service, so I guess that kind of is a speech, but I don't really give speeches too often.
Yeah. So you're, like, in law school, like, are you, do you have to do, like, a lot of public speaking with that?
Well, not quite. I'm still in my undergrad, but when I do go to law school, I can imagine I'll be giving a lot of speeches.
Yes. Yeah, definitely. So describe, like, how you prepare for a speech.
Pretty much you study the material. Mm-hmm. You want to persuade people to their nature and what they understand. So you want to break it down to them so they're able to relate and understand what you're saying. So that's pretty much how I do it.
Yeah, that's a good point. A good way to strategize it. So how often do you get scared when you're talking in front of people?
Not too often because I like to talk. Yeah. So, but if I was to get scared, I'd probably just remember what I'm speaking about and make my message clear.
Yeah, definitely. Cool. Thank you so much.
No problem.
What's your name?
My name is Muhammad.
Muhammad?
Yeah.
Okay, awesome.
Yeah. Like this?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. I'm waiting for him to turn the camera on.
Oh, okay. You're going to ask all the questions?
Yeah.
Ask, like, few questions.
All the questions, and then just make sure you have, like, full sentences and stuff like that. So, like, no one-word answers.
Is one word?
No one word.
Come on.
Yeah, I know. I know. It's one of those requirements.
Be quick. This is a full sentence.
Yeah. Okay.
And you're on.
I'm here with Muhammad. So if you could be any age for a week, what age would that be?
I was going to be 25. Yeah, 25, that's a good age. Mm-hmm. I'd like to go back again.
Yeah.
Be 25 years old. Yeah.
Definitely, that's great. So why would you choose that age?
Because this age, I like to choose different major. There's nothing the right now, the regular current major.
Yes,
definitely. Okay. And then what like makes it so special to be that age?
Because this age, you can choose a lot of stuff. Mm-hmm. Now it's too late to change it now. Yeah.
Well, it's never too late. You can still
know,
try.
I know. I will try my best. But this special will be 25 is better.
Yes, that's true. You have a little bit more time probably. Yeah. So if like at the end of this week, you could stay the same age or would you go back to your real age? Which one would you do and why?
If I'm going to fix everything, I'm going to go back to the real age. Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Awesome. That's great. Mm-hmm. And then let's see. What would you do for like a whole week while you were 25?
Oh God, there's a lot of stuff I'm gonna do. Not only one thing, a lot of stuff. Mm-hmm. Like what I told you, first one, choose the really good measures and a lot of stuff. It's hard to tell right now.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Definitely, that's great. So so your real age, like what do you do now?
I'm a real age now, with 37 years old. Mm-hmm. I'm the assistant manager of Walgreens right now.
Walgreens, you get a bunch of cool stuff from there. Yeah. So what do you do like with your friends and family now?
Right now? Mm-hmm. Try and buy in turkey, try to fix that, eat turkey on the Friday, cool. Thanksgiving, and that's it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Awesome. Well, thank you so
You're
much.
You're welcome. No problem. Awesome. Thank you.
Cool. Thank you.
Have a good No,
I believe it's okay.
Okay, so.
Wait, did you just record it?
It was an interesting part of the tour.
big government topics.
Yeah, it was I've said it so many times. Criticism or something like that. It was like something so programmed. Wait, what? Oh, yeah.
What's your name?
Elion.
Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. Here, I'll take this.
Yep. Now I'm curious.
Oh, I don't think that's on air. Okay, I don't know what I just said.
Perfect. We're back on the air.
Are you sure?
Yep.
Okay, cool. So, wait, Ilion?
Okay.
Ilion. Okay. I'm here with Ilion. So, where do you go to get on a computer and why?
My house or the library
okay.
at my school.
Yeah, definitely. That's a good place to go. So, are you, on the computer for a really long time and why?
No, because, I'm not, a computer person. I'm mostly, iPad, iPhone.
Yeah. Definitely. I have to have those Apple products. So what if you had, no computer? What would you do?
Well, I'll find something I'll do or, go travel around.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Try to figure it out somehow. So how do you...
We're sending those to London.
Okay. So what if you're... Okay, so do you know who, Steve... I don't know how to pronounce his last name. It's, really weird. He is, the co-founder of Apple. So do you know who that is?
Yeah.
Yeah, who is that?
It's Steve Jobs, and he created Apple and made the first Apple computer and Mac.
Yeah, very nice. And then, do you know who his partner of Steve Jobs was?
No, I forgot his name.
His name is also Steve, but I think it's Wozniacki or something. Wozniak. That's how you say it. Yeah.
He made the keyboard.
Yeah, I think that's right. I think I watched a documentary on it. Have you ever seen an Apple documentary?
I watched it 3 times.
Oh, wow.
I like it.
Yeah, definitely. So would you want to really get into, would you ever want to work at Apple?
Yeah, if that was my backup job.
Yeah, definitely. That's very cool. So when did you last sign into, a computer?
Probably a week ago to do, a project.
Nice.
Something.
Yeah, okay, cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Awesome. And then, could I get you to sign in right here?
Yeah, I bet. That's right. I think I watched, a documentary on it. Have you ever seen, an Apple documentary?
12:54.
Definitely. So, did you want to really get into, do you ever want to work at Apple?
No, we can't do the same one twice. What do you have to
have? You don't know yet.
That's very cool.
You don't know yet.
So, when did you
go by that clock. 12:54.
I'll do this one.
Okay, cool. So you can come around.
I'm a bowl maker, so.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so what's your name?
Ozzy.
Ozzy? Yeah. Oh, that's a fun name. It's like the Wizard of Oz. It's like Ozzy. We good? So I'm here with Ozzy. So the first sailing boat was invented actually in Egypt. Have you ever been sailing on a boat?
Yes, I make some.
Oh my gosh, that's so cool. You make boats. Oh wow. That's amazing. So what makes like sailing really fun for you and why?
It's fishing and having the fun in the waves, that relaxing thing.
Yes, yeah, definitely. It's very like soothing, you know? So have you, like, how often do you go like on vacation on a boat?
We own one, so every month we go on a boat.
Yeah, definitely, okay. And then if you had a choice to spend like a week on a boat, would you do that?
Yes, I will. Yeah. It's fun to do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. And then what, like, okay, so if you like could name any of your sailboats that like, you either make or like, you know, something, what name would you give them?
Lucy. Yeah. That's my mom's name, so she's Lucy.
Yeah, okay, great. And then, let's see, what would you spend every like weekend working on your, like, would you ever spend like all weekend working on your sailboats?
Yes. Because you're supposed to have it fixed, yeah. Maintain it.
Yeah, definitely.
You want to be safe in the water, so.
Yeah, I'd be bad if anything happened. So cool, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Awesome.
Okay, so if you, like, could name any of your sailboats that like, you either make or, like, something, what
name
would you call it? Elijah. Elijah. Oh, wait, Elijah?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So.
You're on.
Okay, so I'm here with Elijah. So students who chew gum actually have better like math scores than those that don't. So do you ever chew gum while you're taking a math test?
No, my teachers won't let me mostly.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Yeah, my teachers. Some teachers are like crazy strict about it, and some teachers are like, whatever. So let's see. Where do you like not like? Where would you like never chew gum at?
In reading. I have a mean teacher.
Yeah. Definitely. I had a teacher one time that, like, one of the students, like, put a piece of gum, like, in a book, and she's, like, in love with books and stuff. She's an English teacher. And ever since then, gum is, like, it's the worst thing ever. So she's, like, really strict about that. So do you ever find yourself chewing gum, like, more or less than, like, when you were younger, like, versus now?
Well, now than I used to not in elementary. Now in middle I do mostly,
yeah. Yeah, okay. And then when chewing gum, do you think it's like rude to blow bubbles or anything like that?
Well, if I'm in class, most of the teachers get mad. But like if out of class, yeah, I mostly do.
Awesome. And then what would you do if someone was like totally chomping on their gum while they were talking to you? Like, would you just be like, close your mouth? Or like, what would you do?
I would just walk away.
Just walk away?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And then how often do you step like in someone's gum on the street? And like why?
Once, and I was mad.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And you get an official Guinness sticker.
So. 12:58 a.m.
12:50? It's not 12:50.
He said 12:58.
12:58. I heard 50. Oh. I was just going to sound like that. It
was 45.
Yeah. Cool, thank you. And you get an official Guinness sticker. He said 12:58.
Yeah.
Am I gonna be on TV or something? It's just being broadcast and we have to film it for Candace. So, like, talk to like. What's your name?
Shannon.
Shannon. Okay, yeah. Cool. So all the CCs? Okay. And it's raining right now. How appropriate. Okay. So are we good? I'm here with Shannon. So have you ever danced in the rain before and why?
Have I ever danced in the rain? I don't remember exactly. I know I have. I think when I was younger, I was worried about getting wet in the rain, walking home or something like that. And then I just thought to myself, why not just embrace it and run in the rain? And so I think I ended up running in the rain and it was very exhilarating. So, yeah.
It's cool. It's definitely a fun little thing to do.
Yeah.
There's a song called Dancing in the Rain. Do you know how to sing that song? Like, do you know that song?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Dancing in the rain. I don't remember how it goes. I just know the chorus. Yes. Like, I don't know it very well, though. Sorry.
That's great. That was good, though. Very nice. So where's the craziest place you've danced at?
Craziest place I've danced? Oh, man. I don't know. I think probably, let's see, craziest place I've danced? My boyfriend and I, we dance in the middle of department stores all the time.
Oh, really?
So that's kind of a crazy place to dance.
Yeah, that's a fun little place.
Like in Walmart.
Do you just ever just like dance in the the hallways of Walmart?
Yep, pretty much, yeah.
Awesome, that's
act
good.
Like big dorks, you know.
Definitely. So how many ballet dancers do you know, and do they have any injuries?
Ballet dancers, I don't think I know any, but I know that I have known a ballet dancer in the past, and she had, her feet were really torn up and messed up, like, and she had little, like, bumps on her feet, so I don't know if that's common with ballet dancers, but.
Yeah, I used to do a lot of ballet, so trust me, it's common. So if you could dance, like, choose to dance any kind of certain style, what would be, like, your first choice and why?
I really like swing dancing.
Yeah.
I love partner dancing and being like kind of twirled around, and I love like the energy of it.
Yeah.
So I think that would be it, but I'm not a dancer. It's just hypothetical.
Yes, definitely. That's really cool though. Awesome. So what dancer, do you like from the movie Dirty Dance? Yeah, the Dirty Dancing movies.
What dancer? The main character, a baby, I guess, but I don't know what her name is.
Yeah.
But...
Awesome.
I guess that was pretty Patrick Swayze.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Great. Awesome. Okay, cool. Thank you so much.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Wait, 1, 2, 3.
You don't mind doing it again.
4, 5. Wait, why?
The whole thing?
It wasn't broadcast.
Wait, it's broadcasting.
No, it isn't. That prompt just says go back to music.
Oh, I see.
It's broadcasting.
So it is, you're right.
I was like, what?
Okay.
So you took it off.
Thanks.
Are we got more?
Sure.
Somewhere. Mom's going to do it?
Okay. But where are the questions? Oh.
Are you leaving soon? I have to turn the radio off.
So what's your name?
Bia.
Really? Is that great? Okay,
what's
now
your
you can
name
go.
Today?
Yeah.
You're on.
Okay, so. Okay, I'm here with Leah. So, who's your favorite designer and why?
I probably like Norma Kamali the best. Mm-hmm. She's very cool. She has very high shoulders, like 1980s, which is sort of retro but still sort of popular. So yeah, I like Norma Kamali.
Yeah. Definitely. Bessie Johnson is, like, the way to go.
Bessie Johnson's cute, too.
Yeah, definitely. So what's your favorite thing about that designer?
I think just her very clean lines, and she has very strong shoulders, and she just sort of tapers it. She makes simple look very complicated, but still very cool.
Yeah, definitely. That's awesome. So what, like, do you ever keep up with celebrity gossip?
No, not too much. I don't pay attention to it too much.
Yeah. Okay. And then what's like the biggest Hollywood scandal that sticks out like the most in your mind?
Probably, I haven't kept up to it too much, but probably like a Tom Cruise issue or something. Yeah, he's probably the most that I've sort of heard about.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, awesome. And then do you like buy or like look into like gossip magazines like at the dentist office?
I look at them. If I'm waiting for the dentist a long time, then I look a lot more at them.
Yeah.
And that's about it. I glance at them a little bit.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Thank you.
Thank you.
Awesome. And then if you can sign this.
Let's do a family picture. All the family. But I want a real camera.
I got the camera right here.
Yeah. Real picture.
This one.
We actually do real pictures around here?
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. Shy guy.
Can he get it? Wow.
Oh,
okay.
Hey.
Can he made it back?
Tense bra.
Put mom
oops,
in the
oops.
Middle.
Okay,
gonna
be
okay. Oh, I guess dad's going to be in this. Okay. I was thinking all girls. But
well,
oh,
he's the
I'll go
family
in the middle then.
Okay, are we good?
Perfect.
Okay.
Box behind you. Ready? Big smile. Uh-oh, now we do have rain.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Now we have a
problem. Get the push and get the rain.
I wasn't worried
what are you going to do?
But now we got rain. We're okay under here.
Well, this is safe, right? This is waterproof?
Yeah, it's, I'm assuming.
Right. Pretty much. If it gets
yeah,
bad,
but yeah.
They cover it up. Let's go to radio.
Like
yeah.
You can't put this on the other side, please?
Nah, it'll be okay.
It's you got more water in here on the other side. Honey, let me shove him inside.
No, this camera, I don't
can you shove him inside? Shove him yep inside? Can you move him
yeah,
inside?
Yeah, shove what? Shove what?
Shove yourself inside.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, hold on.
It's raining. Look at that.
Yeah,
switch
the chair,
switch
the chair.
Yeah, you can go the other side.
Yeah, put the chair on the
okay
side.
Okay, we look good.
Yeah, it's a pretty good shot.
Yeah.
Oh, you
daddy, not there.
Right
here.
Oh,
no.
I don't
want to get this
picture.
You
want
to
see? Oh, this
is
on the screen.
You can't
see
the picture on the screen.
Are you sorry?
You can send it to us.
Oh, man.
Look at that.
See, and then stop. How are we doing? It's not raining.
What?
Exactly. Who are you taking a picture of? Do you have a radar on your phone?
I do. Radar.
Radar for
I see
the weather.
See the weather. Do you have that? Can you tell? No.
Paul, I do.
Cold?
Check it out.
It's now
55%.
670
all.
That's what it was all day.
As long as it's not red.
What are you going to do?
Can I sit down? My butt, or no, my back.
You got red?
Oh, and here it came again. I stopped moving it in because all of a sudden it stopped raining. Yeah, now it's raining.
Show me, see if I can.
Yep.
Good. Oh, wait, hold.
Did you look at the radar, Doug?
I didn't get a chance of moving this.
You mean you can't do everything at the same time, Doug?
Yeah.
What? You want to pick out, like, one of these questions, or if you want me to select a random one, that's fine. Okay, let's try it.
Thanks, buddy.
Getting there.
I have a little bag right here. You can put it in the bag.
Can I shove that in your baby juice?
Yep.
We'll just have a good look.
That's mine. Oh, that's not that is mine.
Do we have people?
I don't know. 22nd. Or 23rd, I'm sorry. I'm just saying the 22nd.
We're sitting
here. Yeah,
it's been happening all week.
All right, I got cloudy.
I'll go to right now.
I'm...
You have a good radar. I'm gonna give you the good radar.
I had it. So there it is.
Whoa. That's a visible satellite.
It's not loaded yet. That's the picture. Oh. Yes, sir. I'm sorry.
Can you get me the food to the Pacific Gate?
Yeah, it will do that.
Yes.
Can you get like a napkin for this?
Weather. All right, here we go. That's not looking good.
We're going to be wrapping up, pulling all this stuff in.
Yeah, that's not looking good.
Here's what we do. We're going to take this table, go back against there.
Okay, so
it's going to be out of the frame. That's serious stuff coming down.
Yes, it is. So what are you...
What's your name?
Glenn.
Glenn. Okay, cool. And then I guess we're in the frame.
Make it off of radio.
Marcus, thank you.
Okay, test. Testing, testing. Test. It's right there. Okay, yeah, we're good. Glenn, right? What? Yeah.
Quiet on the set, and you're on.
Okay, I'm here with Glenn. So the world's largest pyramid is actually not in Egypt, but in Mexico. Have you ever been to Mexico, and why?
I have not been to Mexico, but I've heard it's very nice to be in Mexico.
Yeah, definitely. I heard a lot of people go to like vacation there and stuff. So why did you, or like, why would you go to Mexico? Like, what, like, would you just go for fun? Like, what would you go for?
Vacation, fun. And sightseeing, because there's a lot of good pyramids and other things over there.
Yeah, definitely true. Okay, so, let's see. Okay, so if you were to go to Mexico, like, are you able to speak a little bit of Spanish?
Yeah, I am. I'm Puerto Rican, so I can speak Spanish, yeah.
Yeah, well, there you go. Look how awesome that would be. Okay, so in your family, does anyone else speak Spanish fluently?
Yeah, my whole family does.
Yeah.
Okay.
Very cool. So what's like the toughest part of like, you know, travel? Like, what would be like the toughest part of like traveling to Mexico for you? Like, just like time or?
Money.
Really?
Yeah, that'd be the hardest thing. Mm-hmm. I can make the time.
Yes, definitely. Is there any celebrities that you know that are from Mexico?
Not by name, but I've seen them on TV because my parents watch a lot of Hispanic TV.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Very cool. cool. And like, do you ever plan on going to Mexico, like, if you could?
A spring break at some point.
Really?
Yeah.
Awesome.
That's my plan.
Very cool. Thank you so much.
No problem.
Awesome. And then you can go over to her and she can sign you out and stuff.
That's what we could do. We could move it under their red tent, that table.
Yeah.
And walk them right through there. What's he going to get? Let's wrap all this little stuff up. We're going to consolidate all the paperwork.
I've got the tent right now.
Because it may get windy. There is major rain on its way.
Let's get Marcus shot.
We're
going to...
Oh, is there... He's doing that?
Yeah, he's ready. He's ready.
I'm on break.
Okay. Let's do the paperwork last and just get them in there. Stand right over there, Marcus, if you would. On the right-hand side of the clock. There you go.
Works.
Okay,
cool.
Wait, what is this? We'll move that.
It's fine. I just don't like step all over it. Okay.
Make sure you hold the mic until you're done talking. Keep clipping yourself.
And are we good?
Speed.
Yeah. Okay. I'm here with Marcus. So, yes. So, what keys on the keyboard, like, do you not ever use?
I don't use the numbers on the right-hand side for some reason. I don't know why.
Yeah,
I just never use it.
Yeah, you just use like the top numbers?
I was never trained to use the right-hand side numbers for some reason. I don't know why.
Yeah, that's weird. Awesome. So did you like, okay, so did you think I was going to talk about computers or like on a keyboard, like on a computer or like on a piano?
Well, you said keys. Yes. I thought piano at first, but when you said computer, then obviously it's computer, but
yeah.
It kind of threw me off at first, but it's all right. It's all the same. Keys, awesome. Keys.
There you go. Very nice. So if you forget, like, your mouse or, like, for your laptop or whatever, what would you do?
Well, I got touch screen, so I don't use a mouse.
Wow. There
so
you
it's,
go.
Like, both the best worlds. You get to unattach it and everything.
Yeah.
But if you forget it, you got, like, the adapter where you could just plug it in that we sell here.
Yes.
You can plug it in and it just have a portable mouse.
Nice. Yeah. It's all good there to go. You go. Very nice. Okay. And then how often do you have to change, like, your keyboard, like, on your computer? Do you have to, like, change the batteries or anything?
Never. I got a Toshiba.
Okay.
Very nice computer. Got chat out. But other than that, never. It's all good to go.
Awesome. That's great. And then if okay, so where did you learn how to, like, master using a keyboard?
Third grade.
Really?
I had a computer class at the school I used to go to. And I had a real rough teacher. She was not playing. You got to learn it or you failed.
Oh, my gosh.
She wasn't playing.
Wow, it took me until, like, ninth grade, because, like, I've never have to really use the computer that much, but, like, until it came to, like, writing a bunch of essays and stuff.
Oh, yeah, essays. Well, I'm glad I did master it, because, you know, by 12th grade, you got to learn how to, you got to know how to write an essay before you get out of high school. If you don't know how to write an essay, you shouldn't be out of high school.
Yeah, exactly. But. Definitely. And then, are you fast at really typing on the keyboard and stuff?
Sadly, no. I just know how to type real good. I'm not fast at it.
Yeah.
I write better than I type.
Really?
If that makes sense.
Yeah, that's crazy. So where did you learn to, like, really master using the keyboard?
I really mastered it in 11th grade.
Okay.
I had a test I had to take for my senior project.
Okay.
And you had to learn everything about the keyboard, all the buttons, all the functions.
Yeah.
And basically, if you did not know it, you was going to fail.
Yeah.
So you made sure you had it. I made sure I got it down pat.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, and then, yeah, cool. Thank you so much for talking
to
me.
No problem. I hope you get everything squared away.
Yes, thank you.
How many you got left?
I think we only, okay, like the current, how many?
30 or something.
Yeah, like I want to go over the record, so like around 30 now. So okay. We're almost there. We're almost there. All right. Yes, thank you.
No problem.
And then if you could sign something over there.
All right.
He's going to go with the rest of the stuff.
So what we're going to do is wrap up all the paperwork that we don't need and stuff.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. 120. Here. Okay, this does not need to be in the middle of the...
Just keep it so it doesn't get wet. Yes, going in my car. Then we'll, if it pours, there's major rain coming. We saw it on the radar. So what we're going to do, maybe take all the paper, put it in the box, and if we have to go inside, I'm going to stay with the cameras, cover them up, and then everything that could get wet goes inside. Purses, all the paperwork.
Thank you, Marcus. No problem. Paul, you want to shoot me now? Or?
Yeah, let's do it. We'll just do that, knock that off now.
What number are we at?
What
number?
We're
going to
do one more.
We're going to do one more.
Weapon. Your what?
Yeah, good idea. Let's do it now.
He's going to do the numbers.
Yeah, and cool. You can sign the paper it's out there.
Yeah, do you want to do a random thing?
Sure, yeah. Sure.
Okay. Do you play tennis?
Sometimes.
Okay. Pretend like you're an expert at tennis.
Yeah, every Monday. Every Monday.
He's really good, too.
What did you say the correct number was? I thought it was...
And then I'm going to the car with it.
This is a
293.
Is it?
Yeah,
it is. A 293.
Yes. Hello, how are you?
Let's record it and you can do the paperwork, Doug.
That's true.
There we go. All right. Are we ready?
Okay.
Hold on. And you're on.
I'm here with Douglas. So, do you ever play tennis?
Not in a long time, but I used to play.
Yeah, definitely. Okay. What kind of racket would you use? Like a metal one or a wood one?
I had a really nice metal racket, but I like my old wooden ones best.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would be afraid to like break it or something. You know, like when you're trying to like get really into the game or something. So, the USTA is like a big tennis event in Flushing, New York. Have you ever been there?
No, I haven't. But I have been out to the tennis center here in Daytona Beach.
Nice, that's cool. So would you ever travel to make a tennis, a famous tennis event or like a professional one?
I don't know, but I think I'd love to go to Wimbledon.
Okay, yeah, that would be kind of cool. Like, it's all like, yeah, that's amazing. So who would you like to see most at a USTA event?
I'm kind of old school. Yeah. I mean, I'm like really old school, like Jimmy Connors and John McEnroe kind of old time.
Yeah.
Long time ago.
Yes, definitely.
Because I actually grew up in a small town where Jimmy Connors lived like 10 minutes away.
Oh my gosh, that's
so
crazy.
That's when I played tennis, back when Jimmy Connors was a big deal.
Yes, definitely. Serena Williams and I, who's like the big one now, we have the same birthday, so it's
kinda
cool.
That's what you relate in some little way.
Yeah, exactly. So be honest. Do you ever watch the game because you like tennis or no?
I rarely watch tennis on TV.
Yeah.
It's been a while.
Yeah.
That's true.
Okay. Cool. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Pavlina.
All right.